It's time for the Quiver River Electric TribCast pregame, brought to you by Quiver River Electric Cooperative, a Touchstone Energy Cooperative, online at quiver.com.
And good evening and welcome to week three of high school football in the state of Missouri and the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune as the Bowling Green Bobcats, the holders of the trophy, will take on the visiting Clopton-Elsberry IndianHawks here. Bowling Green off to an 0-2 start. Clopton-Elsberry, complete opposite side of the spectrum. They're 2-0 and just rolling over some of the lower opponents in the region, coming off a shutout win over MMA last week after an impressive win over Louisiana in week number one. This offense is rolling, and the defense has been spectacular. Like I said, just 6 points over the first two games, and I think held a pretty good quarterback that MMA has to negative yardage last week. So it is a good defense, much improved over last year, and that comes to, you know, Scheibel loosening the strings a little bit, letting McCann completely take over the defense, and it's worked through the first two games. Now they have to kind of step it up as they get into the meat of their schedule a little bit, starting with Bowling Green tonight.
Yeah, Guccione had four sacks in the last game and led the defense with nine tackles.
Well, you know, you're going to have those situations when you've got five linebackers like Clopton-Elsberry has. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're running, trying to hit the gaps from every direction, and it's a speed defense. They don't have the size, but they're running different things, things that schools around here maybe aren't prepared for as much, but we'll see as they get more into, like I said, the meat of their schedule. Now, Bowling Green, they have their top running back tonight for the first time in Michael Getty, so we'll see if that can improve the offense that had just around 50 yards of total offense a week ago. They're not throwing the ball particularly well. They're not running the ball particularly well. And if those two things aren't working, you're not going to have much offense, and the defense is going to have to tighten up as well. They're kind of in a bad place last week because Palmyra lost in week one. Mm-hmm. And like all the Clopton coaches said, you don't want to face an angry Palmyra ever. And that's what the Bobcats had to do last week. So we'll take a break here on the Quiver River Electric Cooperative TribCast pregame. Talk more about this one, a lot more about this one. It's the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune, and it's coming up on thepeoplestribune.com.
If you're in the market for New Holland Farm equipment, an Exmark mower, or Kinsey planter, see Bowling Green Tractor today. Bowling Green Tractor is celebrating their completely new state-of-the-art shop, newly remodeled showroom to service all your parts, service, and equipment needs. Call Bowling Green Tractor 324-3337 or stop by and check out the expanded shop. Wishing all our area teams the best of luck this year, Bowling Green Tractor.
Many of us are looking for ways to save energy, but please don't take safety shortcuts. Quiver River Electric Cooperative reminds you to use electricity safely and take it seriously. Never touch a down power line after a storm. Always stay at least 10 feet away. Outdoors, look up for power lines and call 811 before you dig. Indoors, keep appliances away from water and don't overload circuits or use damaged cords. A safety message from Quiver River Electric Cooperative, owned by those we serve.
This is Kim Gam, RN, Certified Diabetes Educator and Coordinator of the Pike County Diabetes Counseling Program. Diabetes self-management education is designed to help you understand the disease and learn to manage it. Our nationally recognized program provides quality education and covers all aspects of diabetes management from basic to advanced skills. For more information, contact the Pike County Health Department, Home Health and Hospice at 573-324-2111.
The Pike County Health Department, neighbors helping neighbors.
Well, we're still catching every game, just a lot more from home than here in the stands, huh?
Yeah, and when we do get to go, Dad says we gotta bring our own peanuts and stuff.
Looking for some extra ticket money this season? Let a State Farm agent do a free discount double check that could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
We'll always be there for this team, even when we can't actually be here.
Agent Ramsey Dickerman will be there at 503 West Highway 54 in Vandalia. Online at RamseyDickerman.com.
State Farm is there. Discounts may vary state to state.
This is the Quiver River Electric TribCast pregame, brought to you by Quiver River Electric Cooperative, a Touchstone Energy Cooperative, online at quiver.com.
Welcome back to Bowling Green, getting ready for the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune. This is the second year, right, of the new version of the trophy, the bell.
Mm-hmm.
And we got some youngsters down there checking it out right now in front of the Bowling Green bench because, they are the holders of this trophy, and Clopton-Elsberry would love to take it back to Clarksville with them. And, boy, they are playing good football right now. They have outscored Louisiana and MMA in the first 2 weeks by a combined 112-6 score. And that comes from good offense, good defense, and the quarterback play of Stephen Talbert. He set some records last year. Boy, he has been fantastic to start this season. 330 yards in the first two games, 5 touchdowns, only been intercepted one time. And, you know, he's got a pretty good quarterback coach in Scott Crager. This is a talent that's been brewing for a while. Talbert under center, and, you know, he's a smart guy. He's calm back there.
Yes. He's so calm.
He can read defenses, you know, and that's something it's not exactly a commodity that's shared across a lot of high school quarterbacks. You know, a lot of guys get the yips, you know, back in the backfield when linebackers start coming. Talbert can read that, step up in the pocket or take off, and he can find
patient.
Holes. Yes, yeah. very patient. So their offense is, it's complemented by a deep receiving core. You got Jamin Graham out there. You got Kevin Hammett, Blake Kendall, Frankie Black can catch some passes, Derek Taylor. They're all making contributions, and they can all run the ball after the catch or out of the backfield as well. So a lot of different weapons, a lot of different looks for this Clopton-Elsberry team and that offensive line. They're short on size, but they are, like I said, with the defense, running things that other schools aren't seeing much. They're running a lot of college sets and stunts, and it's just it can open up some holes because opposing defenses are looking for one thing that they see every other week, and Clopton-Elsberry's opening a hole in a totally different direction. Bobcats, they're struggling on both sides of the ball. They've been outscored 109-15 over the first 2 weeks, but they played some big-time opponents. Mm-hmm. Palmyra last week, and they went down to, St. Clair in week one, played a big school down there. So this is a team that it just doesn't get easy. They don't have an mm-hmm. easy game on their schedule, at least not in the foreseeable future. So
Right. They're
looking for positives first and foremost, and the win down the road. They're always looking for a win, but I'm talking about, you know, in this game.
Right.
Let's get one good thing, two good thing, mm-hmm. and maybe that can lead to a win here tonight and down the road.
And team wins.
Exactly. You got to turn the little things into big things, that's mm-hmm. for sure. We'll take a break here on the Quiver River Electric Cooperative TribCast pregame. Lots more coming up. We're about 20 minutes from kickoff here from Bowling Green and the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune right here on TribCast.
Are you still looking for a bank that knows you by name, offers convenient hours, and hometown service? Look no further than Community State Bank of Missouri. Hello, this is Deb Olson. Our Pleasant staff is here to welcome you and service all of your banking needs. Stop by our office in Bowling Green or Troy and experience the banking difference. Community State Bank of Missouri, your hometown community bank since 1887. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Serving our area for almost a century and a half, La Crosse Lumber Company has always offered quality building materials and hardware supplies at reasonable prices, and still does today. Believing a satisfied customer is a repeat customer, La Crosse Lumber Company features free estimates, free delivery, and blueprint services available too. La Crosse Lumber proudly offers Owens Corning Insulation and the top products in the industry in Bowling Green, Louisiana, Clarksville, Vandalia, and beyond, or visit now at lacrosselumber.com.
Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out tough building projects. Bowling Green Ready Mix for all your concrete and concrete supplies, and the only plant locally owned and operated. And Kearns Construction for new homes, remodeling jobs, repair work, and even snow removal. Just call 324-3433 and let the friendly, knowledgeable staff at Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction Company go to work for you.
No matter which team you're rooting for, Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford hopes all our area teams have a wonderful and successful season. Young Enterprise features Aki and Kent Feeds, Askrow and DeKalb Seeds, RCIS Crop Insurance, Fertilizer, Chemicals, Interstate Batteries, and more. Visit online at youngenterprisesinc.com for more information. Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford.
Family Health Pharmacies in Bowling Green in Louisiana offer more prescriptions under more insurance plans for less. That should make you feel better. Family Health Pharmacies is there to help you when you're not feeling your best. Great gift ideas and half-price greeting cards, too. Two convenient locations to serve you. Bowling Green Pharmacy and Hearing Aid Center on the Square in Bowling Green and Family Drug, 301 Georgia in Louisiana. Family Health Pharmacies, just what the doctor ordered.
This is the Quiver River Electric TribCast pregame, brought to you by Quiver River Electric Cooperative, a Touchstone Energy Cooperative, online at quiver.com.
Welcome back to Bowling Green, the site of the 2016 Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune. It was designed by the Trib, delivered to the commissioners who present it to the winning team of this Bowling Green Clopton-Elsberry game. As a gift of this Pike County rivalry, it's a celebration of the Pike County rivalry, and it's been well received over the last couple of years, and especially since we've gone from the Wimbledon-esque platter to this this Farm Bell. It is it's got some meat to it. It's like hoisting the Stanley Cup.
Yeah, it's heavy.
It is. It's something that you know, you take the adrenaline of the win to lift that over your head, and it's kind of special for these kids. Other action around the area tonight, we've got the undefeated Van Far Indians, 2-0, taking on winless Montgomery County, 0-2 on the season. Louisiana, the Bulldogs, travel for the first time. They'll be at Centralia tonight, Centralia 2-0. They're just good at everything, aren't they? The Centralia Panthers, they beat the Lady Bulldogs on the softball diamond yesterday, 17-0, and now they go up against the Bulldogs on the football field here in week number 3. So we'll try and get you updates from those games throughout the evening and follow how that action is going here as we watch our game, Bowling Green and Clopton-Elsberry, the 2016 Commissioner's Trophy here on thepeoplestribune.com.
When you contract with a local company, you're sure to receive friendly, professional service. And that's just what you'll get with Orff Construction. A homegrown company, Orff Construction specializes in residential and commercial projects. A state-certified septic installer, Orff's offers backhoe, skid steer, and excavation services. Call 324-3552 for your next project. And remember, Orff's does basements, grading, and much more. Orff Construction in Bowling Green.
Celebrating their 20th anniversary, Lynn's Heritage House in Louisiana is proudly family-owned and operated. Since 1996, Lynn's Heritage House has offered affordable, home-like senior living featuring the independence you want and the services you need, with 24-hour staffing for the peace of mind that help is available when it's needed. You can rest assured that the residents at Lynn's Heritage House lead independent, rewarding lives. Elegant, affordable, assisted living. Lynn's Heritage House, 800 Kelly Lane in Louisiana.
The Law Office of Briscoe and Brandon reminds you that tonight's game is not only a competitive contest between these two schools, but it's also an educational experience for the students involved. Because high school activities are about learning life values, do your part in keeping our hometown sports a positive experience for everyone. You'll be teaching a positive lesson, and you'll be preserving a proud tradition. A message from the Law Office of Briscoe and Brandon. The choice of a lawyer is an important one and should not be based upon advertisements alone.
In a season of falling temperatures and rising energy bills, your local Bryant professional stands ready to defend your home's comfort. Because when the temperature falls, Bryant turns up the heat efficiently.
Your protectors are Sparks Maintenance Contracting, Heating and Cooling in Bowling Green at 106 Business Highway 61 North, 324-6500, sparksheatingandcooling.com.
Bryant, whatever it takes.
At Pike County Memorial Hospital, we know how important athletics are for your kids. But with an active lifestyle of sports come health risks and safety hazards. As a certified athletic trainer at Pike County Memorial Hospital, I work closely with our primary care physicians, orthopedic doctors, and physical therapists. We can make a difference between safe play and dangerous injuries for your athletes. Working with Louisiana, Bowling Green, and Clopton schools, our goal is to provide the best possible outcome for your athlete. I'm Ryan Pitzer, certified athletic trainer at Pike County Memorial Hospital. We're at work while your athletes are at play.
Proudly serving the area at 201 South Main in Vandalia, Cole Chiropractic Center is proud to support area high school sports action on TribCast. Cole Chiropractic Center invites you to call or stop by if you've suffered a sports injury, work injury, or been involved in any type of auto accident. Dr. Cole at Cole Chiropractic offers gentle chiropractic care, 24-hour emergency services with most insurances accepted. Don't suffer needlessly. Call 594-2663. Cole Chiropractic Center, 201 South Main in Vandalia.
If you're in the market for New Holland Farm equipment, an Exmark mower, or Kinsey planter, see Bowling Green Tractor today. Bowling Green Tractor is celebrating their completely new state-of-the-art shop and newly remodeled showroom to service all your parts, service, and equipment needs. Call Bowling Green Tractor 324-3337 or stop by and check out the expanded shop. Wishing all our area teams the best of luck this year, Bowling Green Tractor.
This is the Quiver River Electric TribCast pregame, brought to you by Quiver River Electric Cooperative, a Touchtone Energy Cooperative, online at quiver.com.
Welcome back to Bowling Green High School, getting ready for the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune, and kind of a nice moment. The Clopton-Elsberry Band and the Bowling Green Band got together for the national anthem, then Coffin got out of there and Bowling Green played the fight song. But now Clopton-Elsberry will play their fight song, because this, in actuality, was supposed to be a Clopton-Elsberry home game to be played at Clopton High School. But with their field issues, the game had to be moved over here. So there is why the Clopton band is welcome here for this Week 3 matchup and the Commissioner's Trophy game. So during the history of this Commissioner's Trophy game, it has been played here more often than at Bowling Green. I think.
I was not aware of that.
Yeah, I think it's only been played two times over there. And how long have we been doing this?
Oh gosh, I'm not sure.
I think this is the seventh one, isn't it? We had the platter for four or 5 years, and this is now
year two with the bell.
With the bell, so. And. I think Clopton-Elsberry's only won it once.
I remember him winning it once.
Yeah.
I know that for sure.
So there you go. The team's getting ready to come on the field. We'll take a quick break and come back with your starting lineups. This is the Quiver River Electric Cooperative TribCast pregame on thepeoplestribune.com.
If you buy electricity from Quiver River Electric Cooperative, you're more than a customer. You're a member, too. What does that mean? It means you have a say in how things run. It means you have equity in Quiver River when there's money left after expenses each year. It means that helping you save electricity is important, because we're in this together. It means you have more than safe, reliable energy. You have power. You have people. Quiver River Electric Cooperative, owned by those they serve. CUIVRE.com.
Pike County Home Health can provide skilled home health services for homebound patients of Pike County. I'm Peggy Summers. Our agency offers a team approach with a registered nurse coordinating needed services. Home health services include skilled nursing, home health aid, social services, physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy, and a certified diabetic program. We do dressing changes, IV therapy, monitor medications, do diabetic foot care, and many other services.
The Pike County Health Department. Neighbors helping neighbors.
Well, we're still catching every game, just a lot more from home than here in the stands, huh?
Yeah, and when we do get to go, Dad says we gotta bring our own peanuts and stuff.
Looking for some extra ticket money this season? Let a State Farm agent do a free discount double check that could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
We'll always be there for this team, even when we can't actually be here.
Agent Cindy Blaylock will be there for you. 201 Georgia Street in Louisiana. Online at cindyblaylockagency.com.
State Farm is there. Discounts may vary state to state.
This is the Quiver River Electric TribCast pregame, brought to you by Quiver River Electric Cooperative, a Touchstone Energy Cooperative, online at quiver.com.
Welcome back. Getting ready for the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune, and it's time for tonight's starting lineups, your Pike County Health Department TribCast starting lineups. Check out all the services your health department offers by stopping by the campus behind Walmart and Bowling Green or online at pikecountyhealth.org. First, the defensive starters, and we'll go with the Clopton-Elsberry IndianHawks. They'll start on the line, a three-man front at defensive end. It's number 15, Donovan Guccione. I don't know. I got stuck there. Mm-hmm. That's the first time I've ever mispronounced Guccione's name. It's because I wasn't looking at the paper. The other end is number 55, Jamison Wolanski, and the nose tackle is number 75, Matthew Dugan. So, again, Guccione, Wolanski, and Dugan. The linebackers, and there are a lot of them, five linebackers. Number 52, Colin Lockhart. 53, Scott Koontz. 56, Damian Walker. 72, Trevor Anthony. And number 5, Derek Taylor are your linebacking core. And the secondary at safety is number 11, Blake Kendall. And your corners are number 20, Kevin Hammett. And number 33, Jamin Graham. So there is your secondary for Clopton-Elsberry. The offensive starters will go with Bowling Green. On the line at center is number 60, Garrett Swarns. The rest of the line looks like this. 55, Josh Sparks. Number 64, Jordan Billings. Number 72, Gavin Comley. And number 73, Maverick Comley. Receiving core, there's four receivers out there, three wide and one tight end. At wide receiver is number 5, Stephen Mers. Number 10, Noah Pafford. And number 89, Bo Brandt. The tight end is number 81, Lane Sutton. In the backfield, at running back, playing his first game of the 2016 season is number 33, Michael Getty, and at quarterback is number 4, Noah Gamm. So he'll be calling the signals for the Bowling Green Bobcats. And those are your Pike County Health Department TribCast starting lineups. Check out all the services your Pike County Health Department offers by stopping by their campus behind Walmart and Bowling Green or online at pikecountyhealth.org. Teams being introduced right now, then we'll have them run out on the field and have our coin toss. We're getting very close to kickoff, just 8 minutes away. It's the Commissioner's Trophy Game presented by the People's Tribune right here on thepeoplestribune.com.
Hello, this is Mary Millen from Community State Bank of Missouri. Some financial institutions make you go through a lot of red tape to get a loan. At Community State Bank, we try to keep things simple. When you talk with us, you're talking to the people who make decisions. Next time you need a loan for whatever reason, come see us. You'll be glad you did. Community State Bank of Missouri, your hometown community bank since 1887. Equal housing lender.
Serving our area for almost a century and a half, La Crosse Lumber Company has always offered quality building materials and hardware supplies at reasonable prices and still does today. Believing a satisfied customer is a repeat customer, La Crosse Lumber Company features free estimates, free delivery, and blueprint services available too. La Crosse Lumber proudly offers Owens Corning insulation and the top products in the industry. In Bowling Green, Louisiana, Clarksville, Vandalia, and beyond, or visit now at lacrosselumber.com.
Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out tough building projects. Bowling Green Ready Mix for all your concrete and concrete supplies, and the only plant locally owned and operated. And Kearns Construction for new homes, remodeling jobs, repair work, and even snow removal. Just call 324-3433 and let the friendly, knowledgeable staff at Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction Company go to work for you.
No matter which team you're rooting for, Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford hopes all our area teams have a wonderful and successful season. Young Enterprise features Akey and Kent Feeds, Askrow and DeKalb Seeds, RCIS Crop Insurance, Fertilizer, Chemicals, Interstate Batteries, and more. Visit online at youngenterprisesinc.com for more information. Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford.
Health pharmacies in Bowling Green and Louisiana offer more prescriptions under more insurance plans for less. That should make you feel better. Family Health Pharmacies is there to help you when you're not feeling your best. Great gift ideas and half-price greeting cards, too. Two convenient locations to serve you. Bowling Green Pharmacy and Hearing Aid Center on the Square in Bowling Green, and Family Drug, 301 Georgia in Louisiana. Family Health Pharmacies, just what the doctor ordered.
When you contract with a local company, you're sure to receive friendly, professional service. And that's just what you'll get with Orff Construction. A homegrown company, Orff Construction specializes in residential and commercial projects. A state-certified septic installer, Orff's offers backhoe, skid steer, and excavation services. Call 324-3552 for your next project. And remember, Orff's does basements, grading, and much more. Orff Construction in Bowling Green.
This is the Quiver River Electric TribCast pregame, brought to you by Quiver River Electric Cooperative, a Touchtone Energy Cooperative, online at quiver.com.
It is just about game time here from Bowling Green. The officials are at the 50-yard line. We'll soon be joined by the captains and coaches to go over the rules for this ball game, and then our coin toss. Then it's time for the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune. At the end of it, we'll award that beautiful bell to the winning team here tonight. And Bowling Green would love to hang on to it, but Clopton-Elsberry wants to take it back home with them for the first time in a while. We'll take a break, come back with the results of your coin flip and the kickoff. It's just around the corner here on the peoplestribune.com.
This is TribCast. Coverage of high school football. Action from the gridiron on the peoplestribune.com is brought to you by Bowling Green Tractor, by Quiver River Electric Cooperative, the Pike County Health Department Home Health and Hospice, by State Farm Insurance Agent Cindy Blaylock in Louisiana and Ramsey Dickerman in Vandalia, by Community State Bank, La Crosse Lumber Company, Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, by Young Enterprises, Family Health Pharmacies, Orff Construction Company, Lynn's Heritage House, the Law Office of Briscoe and Brannan, by Sparks Maintenance Contracting Heating and Cooling, Pike County Memorial Hospital, and by Cole Chiropractic Center. Now, coverage of high school football from the People's Tribune newspaper. This is TribCast.
Captain's out there getting ready for the coin toss, and then we'll have our Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune newspaper. And boy, it is beautiful. Beautiful bell. Get off Mr. McSparren and zoom in on that bell a little bit. It is nice. Hand-painted, beautiful base, and the full farm bell. You can see it there. We'll go to the winner of this ball game for the second year after we had a nice silver platter for a couple of years. Bowling Green won the toss. They'll have, they deferred to the second half, so they'll be kicking off to Clopton-Elsberry. That'll happen when we come back. It's time for football here on the peoplestribune.com.
Celebrating their 20th anniversary, Lynn's Heritage House in Louisiana is proudly family-owned and operated. Since 1996, Lynn's Heritage House has offered affordable, home-like senior living featuring the independence you want and the services you need. With 24-hour staffing for the peace of mind that help is available when it's needed. You can rest assured that the residents at Lynn's Heritage House lead independent, rewarding lives. Elegant, affordable, assisted living. Lynn's Heritage House, 800 Kelly Lane in Louisiana.
The Law Office of Briscoe and Brannan reminds you that tonight's game is not only a competitive contest between these two schools, but it's also an educational experience for the students involved. Because high school activities are about learning life values, do your part in keeping our hometown sports a positive experience for everyone. You'll be teaching a positive lesson, and you'll be preserving a proud tradition. A message from the Law Office of Briscoe and Brannan. The choice of a lawyer is an important one and should not be based upon...
Now, more TribCast coverage of high school sports from the Bowling Green Tractor broadcast booth. Bowling Green Tractor, your New Holland agriculture equipment dealer, 1201 Business 61 South in Bowling Green.
Kickoff brought to you by La Crosse Lumber Company. Everything you need to start your next building or DIY project at a location close to you. La Crosse Lumber Company, getting the job done. And it'll be Josh Sparks to kick off. And he does kick it deep. Played on a bounce and going down the sideline. And what a huge hit laid on by Michael Getty. He is amped up to play, isn't he? His first action, and he puts a huge hit on. Guccione on the return, and he got popped by Getty. Wow. So Talbert brings the offense onto the field. That woke up the home crowd. First and 10 from the 30-yard line for the Clopton-Elsberry offense. They put a man in motion, two receivers to each side. It's a handoff on first down, and they miss a tackle, and it'll be a gain of 3 on the first carry of the evening for number 13, Frankie Black. So Black gets the first shot with the ball for Clopton-Elsberry. It'll be 2nd and 7.
Where'd they start from?
The 30. So 2nd and 7 for the Indian Hawks. Again, they put a man in motion, loading up one side of the offense, and they go to the air for the first time for Talbert, and he's almost intercepted.
Ooh.
A couple of Bobcats there on the coverage. It looked like Noah Pafford was in the area. Yeah, he gets the deflection on that one. It'll be 3rd. Third and 7. This a long 3rd down play. Talbert in the shotgun. Two receivers to each side. And he's going to take off. He's met and dropped by Garrett Swarns. And Clopton-Elsberry will have to punt. Loss of 3 on the play. It'll be 4th and 10. So not a great first series for the Indian Hawks, and that's what a big hit will do. It'll set tone. And this Bowling Green defense got amped up by that Getty hit. And what do we have? The officials, oh, it's a timeout called by the defense. By the defense. We'll take a break, too. First quarter action, 10:45 to go. No score on TribCast.
In a season of falling temperatures and rising energy bills, your local Bryant professional stands ready to defend your home's comfort. Because when the temperature falls, Bryant turns up the heat efficiently.
Your protectors are Sparks Maintenance Contracting Heating and Cooling in Bowling Green at 106 Business Highway 61 North, 324-6500, sparksheatingandcooling.com.
Bryant, whatever it takes.
Well, I think it was going to be a short snap punt, but the offense was on the field for Clopton-Elsberry. Bowling Green couldn't adjust and had to take the timeout. So it'll be 4th and 10. They do have a deep man out there, just in case. Now he steps back to punt. High snap. Kick is off. And trapped, and the ball is loose. Who's going to fall on it? I think Bowling Green might have it. Flag comes in way late from the far sideline. And it is Bowling Green ball. Pafford finally got it after it bounced short of Bo Brandt. You just got to get out of the way of that ball. Don't let it hit you. But the flag, we'll see. They pick it up.
At the 31-yard line?
Right at the 30. Tail end of the ball on the 30-yard line. First and 10, so both teams started from their own 30. So let's see Gam and the Bowling Green offense for the first time on TribCast this year. Again, 5 linebackers out there for the Indian Hawks. From the shotgun, Gam puts a man in motion. That's Stephen Mers. Handoff is to Mers, and he fumbles. It's fallen on by Clopton-Elsberry IndianHawk, ball deep in Bowling Green territory. And you see Mers head down. He never had the ball under control. Jamin Graham with the recovery. And Clopton-Elsberry will have it. First and 10 from their own 23. Or from the Bowling Green 23. So a shaky start for both teams offensively. And you see, you had the big Getty hit. Clopton-Elsberry stalled on their first possession. You have that flubbed punt return, and then they fumble on the very next play. And it's another fumble, and this time I think Bowling Green has it. They do. Jordan Billings on the recovery. So it ends up being a five-yard loss for Bowling Green, the fumble and then fumble recovery.
Who was the fumble on?
It was a bad snap to Talbert.
So we're at the 25-yard line now?
Yeah, so it was just a net five-yard loss. On the run is Getty. And he is across the 25 to about the 28, the 27. So it'll be second and 8. Second down for the Bobcats. And they put a man in motion. Then they go up the gut. And fighting for more is Getty, and he gets it out to about the 34-yard line. Wolanski on the stop, and it'll be third and about a yard and a half. Officially a gain of 6 for Getty. Clopton late setting the defense. Gam takes it himself. There's a hold. This play's coming back. He had enough for the first down. This one's coming back. It is a hold against the Bobcats. That'll negate the first down. 10-yard penalty from the spot. So it's going to be third and about 12. It was right at the line of scrimmage, it looked like. So the Bobcats going backwards. Neither team rolling here early.
Looks like it's going to be a third and 12 for the Bobcats.
9:10 to go in the first quarter. No score. Both teams have turned the ball over. Clopton-Elsberry had a 3-and-out to start the game. Game in the shotgun. Drops back, throws to the far side, and it is almost picked off. Almost picked off by Jamin Graham. They said it was intercepted? Did he tip it to himself? Huh.
Really?
Yeah, I thought I saw it roll. But they give it to Clopton-Elsberry. Second turnover of the contest. Wow. I'm going to have to go back and watch the replay of that one later tonight. Jamin Graham on the pick. So he has recovered two turnovers for Clopton-Elsberry. Recovered a fumble and intercepts a pass. So Talbert back on the field, and he's dropping back to throw. He's going deep, and it is almost caught off the knee. There on the coverage, Matt Kay. And they'll do it again. They were going deep. It was a little underthrown. But we saw in week one against Louisiana, that doesn't matter to these Clopton-Elsberry receivers. They've got good concentration. Second and 10. Talbert back to throw again. This one's a short pass, and it's caught on the far side. And finally brought out of bounds at the 25-yard line is number 20, Kevin Hammett, on the reception. So that's enough for a first down. Gain of about 15. Brant and Pafford on the stop, but not until after Clopton-Elsberry converts the first down. Has it first and 10 from the 16-yard line. Indian Hawks looking to pull ahead here in the first quarter. Talbert back to throw again. This is one of their best. That one is caught for the touchdown. Touchdown Indian Hawks. Blake Kendall, 16-yard reception. Kendall puts Clopton-Elsberry on top, and they'll go for two. Time of the touchdown, 8:21 remaining in the first quarter. Put a man in motion, that's Kendall on the two-point play. Fake the run up the middle. It's put in the air, and it is caught for the two-point conversion. Kendall again catches two, one for a touchdown, one for a two-point conversion, and Clopton-Elsberry leads it 8-0, 8:21 to go in the first. This is TribCast.
At Pike County Memorial Hospital, we know how important athletics are for your kids. With an active lifestyle of sports comes health risks and safety hazards. I'm Eric Schaefer, certified athletic trainer at PCMH, and I work closely with our primary care physicians, orthopedic doctors, and physical therapists. Working with Clopton, Bowling Green, and Louisiana schools, we strive to prevent, diagnose, and treat a wide variety of injuries, ranging from sprains and fractures to heat stroke and concussions. In addition to sports coverage, we offer impact testing for head injuries as well as athletic enhancement for those athletes looking to get a step ahead of the competition. Rest assured, we're at work while your athletes are at play.
Talbert to Kendall for 16, and then the two-point conversion between the same two. It's 8-0 Clopton-Elsberry, 8:21 to go in the first quarter, and the Indian Hawks getting ready to kick off to the Bobcats as the teams traded three turnovers before that touchdown. Fumble on consecutive plays, then an interception a couple of plays later. Kuntz on to kick off. Kay back deep for the Bobcats. He wears number 22. Kick off of the hands again. It's picked up. Nope. Oh, wow. Still having trouble with it, and brought down is number 2, Kaylee O'Dade. Just could not pick that ball up, could he?
No.
Finally did, but by that time, half the Clopton-Elsberry defense was right on top of him. It'll be first and 10 from their own 19 for the Bobcats. Hand off to Getty on first down. He cuts it back up the middle, and he's trying to beat the defense. Finally tripped up at the 40-yard line. Great run by Michael Getty for the Bobcats. Gets 20 yards. Make it 22 yards from his own 19 to the 41. That's a run there for Getty. Eight minutes to go in the first quarter. This run by Dade for the Bobcats. Stiff arm gets him out near the 50-yard line. It'll be second and 2 after a gain of 8. Jamin Graham on the stop. So right in front of us here in the Bowling Green Tractor broadcast booth. On second and two. Dade again. He's got the first down. He's up the middle, and he's across the 40-yard line of the IndianHawks. There is a flag. We'll see what the flag is all about. They're talking about it. And it is a hold. Hold against the defense. So that'll add 10 more yards. Move that ball even farther down the field.
How much did Dave get on that last carry?
It looked like about 18 yards. So they'll hit it first and 10 from the IndianHawk 29. Game in the offense. Have had success with that run up the middle the past couple plays. Going to try it again. There's Dade. He's upended. They shift that time. There on the tackle is number 57. Oh, 53 rather. That's Koontz. Second and eight for the Bobcats. Back to throw again is Gam. Puts it to the far side. It's caught over there on the far side by number five, Stephen Mers. Enough for the first down all the way down to the 15-yard line. Bobcats looking to answer here.
How many yards did Mers get on that?
Looked like about 13. So the Bobcats, who were shut out last week, looking to get in the end zone. Here's Dade, reverses field. Nice cut, but not much there after that. Gain of one, maybe two. It'll be second and eight.
Right down there by number 15, Donovan Guccione.
Guccione on the stop for the IndianHawks. The Bobcats will spread it out. Getty in the backfield for this second and nine play. And the give is to Getty, looking for the corner of the end zone, and he gets down to about the 6 yard line.
That Mers?
That was Getty. So it'll be right at about a yard short, third and one. Getty back there again. There's the hand. Fighting. I think he has enough for the first down with forward progress. Did he get the ball across? No, they're going to signal fourth down. No gain on the play. Still need one, and they bring in a big body. That's Marlon Dade in it running back now to try and get this yard. Or clear some space. And they got the 1 yard, almost got it in the end zone. In a wildcat there with Stephen Mers at quarterback, and he runs it down to the one. First and goal. First and goal, they're going to try the same setup here. And flags come out, too many men on the field for Clopton-Elsberry. As Matthew Dugan, they called the timeout instead. Dugan couldn't get off. He was running his fastest. We have a timeout on the field. We'll take one, too. Right now, it's 8-0 IndianHawks. Bowling Green knocking on the door on TribCast.
Proudly serving the area at 201 South Main in Vandalia, Cole Chiropractic Center is proud to support area high school sports action on TribCast. Cole Chiropractic Center invites you to call or stop by if you've suffered a sports injury, work injury, or been involved in any type of auto accident. Dr. Cole at Cole Chiropractic offers gentle chiropractic care, 24-hour emergency services with most insurances accepted. Don't suffer needlessly. Call 594-2663. Cole Chiropractic Center, 201 South Main in Vandalia.
If you're in the market for New Holland Farm equipment, an Exmark mower, or Kinsey planter, see Bowling Green Tractor today. Bowling Green Tractor is celebrating their completely new state-of-the-art shop and newly remodeled showroom to service all your parts, service, and equipment needs. Call Bowling Green Tractor 324-3337 or stop by and check out the expanded shop. Wishing all our area teams the best of luck this year, Bowling Green Tractor.
First and goal for the Bobcats after the timeout. Still got the meat up front, and here's Mers, and he is tackled around the neck, brought down short of the goal line. It'll be second and goal. Kuntz, the first man there for the Indian Hawks. They'll try again with Dade leading the way. And he is in for the score. Mers from 1 yard out. That makes it 8-6 Indian Hawks with the extra point yet to come. Time of the touchdown. 4:16 remaining in the first quarter. Bowling Green on the board. Now they'll set up and try and tie it with the two-point conversion. Same formation for the Bobcats. Trying to get Mers in there again. This time he's going for the outside, and he is gang tackled. And that'll be our score, 8-6. Kickoff coming up. Bowling Green has gotten within two here on thepeoplestribune.com.
Many of us are looking for ways to save energy, but please don't take safety shortcuts. Quiver River Electric Cooperative reminds you to use electricity safely and take it seriously. Never touch a down power line after a storm. Always stay at least 10 feet away. Outdoors, look up for power lines and call 811 before you dig. Indoors, keep appliances away from water and don't overload circuits or use damaged cords. A safety message from Quiver River Electric Cooperative, owned by those we serve.
This is Kim Gam, RN, Certified Diabetes Educator and Coordinator of the Pike County Diabetes Counseling Program. Diabetes self-management education is designed to help you understand the disease and learn to manage it. Our nationally recognized program provides quality education and covers all aspects of diabetes management from basic to advanced skills. For more information, contact the Pike County Health Department, Home Health and Hospice at 573-324-2111.
The Pike County Health Department, neighbors helping neighbors.
Brant on to kicking off after the 1 yard Stephen Mers touchdown. 2 point conversion no good. 4:16 to go in the first quarter. We got a 2 point ball game. They kick it deep. Boy, that's a nice kick. All the way deep and receiving it on the fly for the Indian Hawks. And taking it out to the 30 yard line is Blake Kendall. Brendan Henderson on the stop for the Bobcats. It'll be first and 10 as Talbert. And the Indian Hawks starting from the 30 for the second time in this ballgame. The first time they were that deep in their own territory, it was a three and out. That started the ballgame. Eight to six Indian Hawks. Fourth possession, and the Bobcats were jumping. We'll see if they were drawn offside or if they gave Clopton-Elsberry a free five. Yep, it was on the defense. It'll be first and five for Clopton-Elsberry. It's a little bit easier for Talbert and the Indian Hawk offense. And Talbert takes it himself. He's stopped at the line of scrimmage. Falls forward for a yard. It'll be second and four. Malcolm Lewis and Jordan Billings in on the stop for the Bobcats. Gain of one for Clopton-Elsberry. They've got some beef, this Bowling Green offensive line, or defensive line, rather. They're going to win some battles there. On second down and four, it's again a keeper. Talbert sidesteps a man, gets into the secondary, trying to get away, and finally brought down at the 47-yard line, making the 48. Bo Brandt finally got him, but it's just short of midfield and enough for a first down.
12 yards on that.
Sounds right.
Yep. That was amazing. He was
that one cut left that man in the dust. 3:15 to go in the first quarter. Talbert looks over. Now comes up again out of his stance. Now the Indian Hawks are set with one on the play clock. High snap. He was able to control it. Tripped, still on his feet, drug down, and gang tackled after that. Just couldn't get it under control there. Jordan Billings, Malcolm Lewis in there. Loss of three on the play. It'll be second and 13. I'm guessing that was a timing play, and the high snap just threw it completely off. No check downs on that one. 13 on the play clock, 2:20 in the first quarter remaining. Good snap this time. Talbert takes off. Rolls off a man. He's going to be hit for a loss again. Looks like another yard loss. It'll be third and 14. So the runs aren't working right now. Look for something deep down the sideline here. Big third down. They put four receivers out there. Another man in the backfield for the Indian Hawks. Fakes the handoff. Steps up, and he is sacked. Dade was there. Swarns was the first man. And Clopton-Elsberry back to their own 36. That's a loss of 10. Bring up fourth down. So the 30 is not a good place for Clopton-Elsberry to start.
No.
Their two drives that have started at the 30 have both fizzled out. Talbert gets the kick off. It's tracked down. Sidestep and out of bounds. Out of bounds is the deep man, Noah Pafford. And that's where Bowling Green will take over at their own 17-yard line. First and 10 for Bowling Green. Pafford and Gam back there along with Getty. Now Pafford will split out wide. Getty takes the handoff. Met and dropped. I believe the first man there was Dugan for the Indian Hawks. Gain of maybe 3 inches. It'll be second down. Trevor Anthony also there for the Indian Hawks. On second and roughly 10. High snap gives to Getty again. Nope. Fake handoff and almost intercepted. Taylor was the man there for the Indian Hawks. I fell for the play action. Third and 10 for the Bobcats. Must mean that Noah concealed it pretty good. That'll do it. Well, 1 second will do it for the first quarter. Here's Gam. Looking around. Ball's out. And it is recovered inside the 10-yard line by the IndianHawks. It just fell out of his hand. Just fell out of his hand. Guccione falls on it, and the IndianHawks have it at the 6-yard line when the second quarter begins here in the Commissioner's Trophy game on TribCast.
Well, we're still catching every game, just a lot more from home than here in the stands, huh?
Yeah, and when we do get to go, Dad says we got to bring our own peanuts and stuff.
Looking for some extra ticket money this season? Let a State Farm agent do a free discount double check that could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
We'll always be there for this team, even when we can't actually be here.
Agent Ramsey Dickerman will be there at 503 West Highway 54 in Vandalia. Online at RamseyDickerman.com.
State Farm is there. Discounts may vary state to state.
Are you still looking for a bank that knows you by name, offers convenient hours, and hometown service? Look no further than Community State Bank of Missouri. Hello, this is Deb Olson. Our Pleasant staff is here to welcome you and service all of your banking needs. Stop by our office in Bowling Green or Troy and experience the banking difference. Community State Bank of Missouri, your hometown community bank since 1887. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Serving our area for almost a century and a half, La Crosse Lumber Company has always offered quality building materials and hardware supplies at reasonable prices and still does today. Believing a satisfied customer is a repeat customer, La Crosse Lumber Company features free estimates, free delivery, and blueprint services available too. La Crosse Lumber proudly offers Owens Corning insulation and the top products in the industry. In Bowling Green, Louisiana, Clarksville, Vandalia, and beyond, or visit now at lacrosselumber.com.
Second quarter begins with the score 8-6, Clopton-Elsberry, but they recover a fumble. It was inside the 10-yard line, about the 7. And that's where Clopton-Elsberry takes over. Second fumble by the Bobcats, third turnover in the game for Bowling Green. An interception and a fumble. Talbert drops back, fades it toward the corner of the end zone, and it is caught by Bowling Green, but taken away by Taylor, and that's a touchdown. It was right into the hands of Matt Kay, and then taken out of his hands by Derek Taylor for the touchdown. Wow. Did I say Clopton-Elsberry's good at that? Makes it 14-6.
Who took it away?
Derek Taylor.
Derek Taylor.
They had it played perfectly. Bowling Green did. The coach has called out fade up here, and that's exactly what happened. Now a handoff going for two and stopped short. It'll be 14-0. It was Blake Kendall on the carry. So 14-6. Brandt on the stop. And the IndianHawks in the end zone again to lead this one 14-6 with 11:52 in the second quarter. This is TribCast.
Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out tough building projects. Bowling Green Ready Mix for all your concrete and concrete supplies, and the only plant locally owned and operated. And Kearns Construction for new homes, remodeling jobs, repair work, and even snow removal. Just call 324-3433 and let the friendly, knowledgeable staff at Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction Company go to work for you.
Clopton-Elsberry to kick off after the touchdown by Derek Taylor. I tell you what, Kay just hung his head. He knew he had an interception there, and it was just stolen from him. Have you seen Taylor, though? Boy, he is big and strong. I don't know if you've seen him up close, but my goodness. Kick goes deep, and it bounces past Kay. He picks it up at about the 10-yard line, takes a wide turn, trying to get up the middle. Spins off a tackle, but caught by the ankle by number 55, Jameson Wolanski. Good return for Kay. First and 10 for the Bobcats. They trail by a touchdown and a two-point conversion.
At the 19-yard line.
Yes. First and 10. Pafford. Actually, it's Dade in at quarterback now. Handoff and maybe a yard. Getty, and he does get 1 yard. It'll be second and 9. Jamin Graham on the stop. Colin Lockard also there.
Who's on? Who had the carry?
Getty. Clock running down to 11:18 to go in the first half of this Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune. Dade in the backfield along with Getty. High snap, almost turned it over again. Dade will take it himself and back to the 20, no gain on the play. It'll be third down and 9. They say it was a gain of 1. It was about 3 inches, if anything.
He was generous.
Down to 10:35 to go in the half. Dade in the shotgun, dropping back to throw. Now he takes off to the far sideline. Puts it in the air at the end, and it's overthrown. His intended target was Noah Pafford. Two flags. I think it's going to be a hold against the Bobcats. Against the defense again? No.
Sorry, holding against the offense.
Yeah.
Penalty is declined.
It'll be fourth and 9. And the Bobcats bring on the punt team. It's turned out to be a pretty entertaining first half, hasn't it? They get the kick off. It's short. Bounces at the 45 and goes back to the 41-yard line. And it's down by the Bobcats, so Indian Hawks will take over in Bobcat territory.
At the 45?
At the 41. Yep, it hit on its nose about the 44, bounced back to the 41, and was down by Dade. So that's where the Indian Hawks will take over first and 10. Coming off a scoring drive are the Indian Hawks. Give us to the near side, and they're across the 40 to about the 37. Blake Kendall. Finally tackled by Dade for the Bobcats. Gain of 3 on the play, second and 7. Now it's Frankie Black in the backfield along with Talbert. And you got 4 wide receivers, 2 to each side. Now they put Graham in motion and give him the carry. And they weren't buying it, the Bobcats. Getty as 33 hits 33 there. And it's a loss of about 5. And that'll mean the Indian Hawks are going to go to the air, right? Here for this third down and long. Trips to the far side for the Indian Hawks. One receiver on the near side. Talbert. Long drop. Coming to the near side now. Gets past a couple of men and finally hit from behind by Getty, but it looks like it may be enough for a first down. He's across the 30 to the 25. It is. Gain of 15 on the play, and we've got a man down, and I think it might be Talbert. Right on the sideline. It is an Indian Hawk player, I believe.
Yep, the official. The only one I don't see, so.
Yeah, I think he just got the wind knocked out of him.
Yeah.
And it is Stephen Talbert, and he is okay. He'll have to come out for a play, so we'll see what the Indian Hawks can.
I didn't realize Mike Shiwell could run that fast.
Yeah, he's an athlete now.
I mean, he was a bolt of lightning over there.
1.21 gigawatts. A timeout taken by Clopton-Elsberry. I think that means that they can keep Talbert in the game for the next play. 8:41 to go here in the second quarter. 14-6, Clopton-Elsberry leads.
No matter which team you're rooting for, Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford hopes all our area teams have a wonderful and successful season. Young Enterprise features Akey and Kent Feeds, Askrow and DeKalb Seeds, RCIS Crop Insurance, Fertilizer, Chemicals, Interstate Batteries, and more. Visit online at youngenterprisesinc.com for more information. Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford.
Family Health Pharmacies in Bowling Green in Louisiana offer more prescriptions under more insurance plans for less. That should make you feel better. Family Health Pharmacies is there to help you when you're not feeling your best. Great gift ideas and half-price greeting cards, too. Two convenient locations to serve you. Bowling Green Pharmacy and Hearing Aid Center on the Square in Bowling Green and Family Drug, 301 Georgia in Louisiana. Family Health Pharmacies, just what the doctor ordered.
First and 10 for the Indian Hawks after the timeout. Talbert is okay. But he is replaced for a play, and it is a run up the gut. Putting the ball away is Frankie Black on the carry as Sean Yates gave him the handoff. So here comes Talbert back in there. Jordan Billings finally got him, but it's a gain of 7. Clock down to 8:16 as they hit the line. Talbert back in there after a one-play absence. He got the wind knocked out of him, which is easy to do on the receiving end of a Michael Getty hit. And did they get enough for the first down? I think it's short. Gain of about 2. It'll be 3rd and 1. So back-to-back carries for Frankie Black. And a very manageable third down for the Indian Hawks. Do you take a shot here? Four wide receivers out there on 3rd and 1.
No way I get the yard.
They're going to take their shot. They're going for it on the far side. It is through the hands of Taylor that time. On the coverage for the Bobcats was Noah Pafford. And it'll bring up 4th down and less than a yard.
Who was that intended for?
Derek Taylor.
Yeah, there he is.
Stops the clock with 7:33 remaining in the second quarter. 4th and 1. Talbert in an empty backfield. Going up the gut, and he sidesteps a man, has the yard, still spinning, and finally brought down by a couple of Bobcats. He went flying. Of course that was Getty. Of course that was Getty on the end of that. But it is a 1st down, so they convert the 4th down play. And have
how many yards with that?
He's inside the 10, so close to 10 yards on the play. Whenever you see legs flying in the air, you know Michael Getty is involved.
He's a tough, tough kid.
He just loves to hit.
Yep.
It's his favorite thing in the world. 2 in the backfield now. give is up the gut, and that is enough for the touchdown. Frankly Black from, what was that, 9 yards out? 6:59, the time of the touchdown. Black into the end zone for the Indian Hawks to make it 20-6. Frankie Black. As the Clopton-Elsberry band plays on the far sideline. I love it when there's two bands at a game. Doesn't that just add a ton? Makes that more college-like atmosphere. Going for two are the Indian Hawks again. Talbert in the backfield. Along with Black now, he turns into a blocker, and the throw is into the end zone and caught by number 20 for the Indian Hawks, Kevin Hammett. The two-point conversion is good, make it 22-6. With 6:59 to go in the first half, nearing the midway point of the second quarter, Clopton-Elsberry in control. Bowling Green getting the ball back when we return here on the PeoplesTribune.com.
When you contract with a local company, you're sure to receive friendly, professional service. And that's just what you'll get with Orff Construction. A homegrown company, Orff Construction specializes in residential and commercial projects. A state-certified septic installer, Orff's offers backhoe, skid steer, and excavation services. Call 324-3552 for your next project. And remember, Orff's does basements, grading, and much more. Orff Construction in Bowling Green.
Now more TribCast coverage of high school sports from the Bowling Green Tractor broadcast booth. Bowling Green Tractor, your X-Mark professional turf care equipment dealer, 1201 Business 61 South in Bowling Green.
Black with the touchdown, two-point conversion, a throw is good to Hammett, and it's a 22-6 lead for the Indian Hawks. Kick goes deep to K. He fields it about the 15, makes a cut, he's across the 30. Finally brought down near the 40-yard line. Nice return by Matt Kay. Wolanski on the stop. That is where they spot the ball is the 39. Good field position for the Bobcats to start their next drive.
I need some positives going their way fast.
Yeah, it's pretty much been a stall since their first score, their only score. The give is to Getty. He's met and dropped. Ball comes out. And that is a fumble. Blake Kendall on the hit. Fumble by Getty. And the Indian Hawks recover. One play, and it's another turnover. Back to Clopton-Elsberry. Boy, Talbert just put that, actually it was Hammett, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Kendall on the hit. He put his head right on the ball. Blake Kendall. I knew I'd get there. So Clopton-Elsberry takes over at the Bowling Green 37-yard line. First and 10. You were talking about needing a positive. That is a huge minus put into the column by Bowling Green. Talbert sets, looking for somebody. Boy, this just looks like it's going to be a holding call at some point. He does put it in the air, and it's thrown away. Actually did have a man in the area. That was Blake Kendall again. Game on the coverage, but that was all about flushing Talbert from the pocket. Second and 10 for the Indian Hawks. Stephen Talbert wasn't going to take a loss on that play.
No.
He was going to run as far backward as he could. A la Tecmo Bowl. He throws it up the middle this time, and it's dropped by Taylor. Taylor looked up the field before he had that ball in his possession, and it's third and 10. It almost looks like Clopton-Elsberry's treating this like a free free possession and just going for going for broke. And a timeout taken before this third down and 10 play for Clopton-Elsberry. 6:24 to go in the first half, 22-6. Clopton-Elsberry leads in the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune.
Celebrating their 20th anniversary, Lynn's Heritage House in Louisiana is proudly family-owned and operated. Since 1996, Lynn's Heritage House has offered affordable, home-like senior living featuring the independence you want and the services you need. With 24-hour staffing for the peace of mind that help is available when it's needed. You can rest assured that the residents at Lynn's Heritage House lead independent, rewarding lives. Elegant, affordable, assisted living. Lynn's Heritage House, 800 Kelly Lane in Louisiana.
30-second timeout, and back on are the Indian Hawks offense facing a third and 10. After some good work by the Bowling Green defense following a turnover. Four wide receivers, three to the near side. Talbert going to the far side. And it is caught and a score. Derek Taylor on the reception caught it over his back shoulder. And Clopton-Elsberry at it again. They extend the lead to 30-6. 28-6. With 6:16 to go. 2-point conversion yet to come, trying to make it 30. What a catch. What a throw by Talbert. That was perfect positioning.
Yeah, it was.
And Derek Taylor on the end of it.
All he had to do was just stick a hand out.
He didn't even have to stick it out far. That was right on his shoulder.
37-yard pass.
Put a man in motion for the 2-point conversion. Talbert back to throw again. Rolls out, puts it in the air, and it is incomplete. Separated from Jamin Graham by a couple of Bobcats. I think first contact was by Noah Pafford, and the 2-point conversion is no good. So Clopton-Elsberry scores again. They lead it 28-6, capitalizing on a Bowling Green turnover here on the PeoplesTribune.com.
The Law Office of Briscoe and Brandon reminds you that tonight's game is not only a competitive contest between these two schools, but it's also an educational experience for the students involved. Because high school activities are about learning life values, do your part in keeping our hometown sports a positive experience for everyone. You'll be teaching a positive lesson, and you'll be preserving a proud tradition. A message from the Law Office of Briscoe and Brandon. The choice of a lawyer is an important one and should not be based upon advertisements alone.
In a season of falling temperatures and rising energy bills, your local Bryant professional stands ready to defend your home's comfort. Because when the temperature falls, Bryant turns up the heat efficiently.
Your protectors are Sparks Maintenance Contracting Heating and Cooling in Bowling Green at 106 Business Highway 61 North, 324-6500, sparksheatingandcooling.com.
Bryant, whatever it takes.
Now this time they kept it away from Matt Kay, but it's picked up, and Dade returns it almost to the 50-yard line. So good field position. Coons finally got him, but good position for the Bobcats.
And that's how it started last time.
Yeah, with good field position for the Bobcats.
Mm-hmm. And the very next.
Very next play, yeah. I don't fault Getty for that last fumble. That was just a good hit put on by Kendall.
Yes.
Well, you got three potential quarterbacks out there. You got Gam, you got Dade, and Pafford. You got Mers.
Mers, that's what I meant.
The give is to Dade. He's across the 50. Ooh. Into open field and finally brought down at the Indian Hawk 39-yard line. Kaleo Dade, but there is a flag, and it's going to come back. That's a hold. Holding against the Indian Hawks, or against the Bobcats, rather, and it's going to come back. So it'll be, it looks like it's right about the line of scrimmage. So it's going to be first and 20 for Bowling Green. That's a killer.
from the 36.
Get that great field position and then
shoot themselves in the foot. Dade switches sides. Gam throws it to the far side for Pafford, or for Mers. Gain of four. It'll be second and 16. Blake Kendall on the stop for the Indian Hawks. He's been all over the place. Down to 5:15 to go here in the second quarter. Give is to Dade. And he's brought down after a gain of a couple. It'll be third and about 14. This is a big down for the Bobcats. They need to do something here. Pump fake, throws across the middle, and it's incomplete. Nowhere close to the intended target, Stephen Mers. That was 5 yards off of where it should have been. So it'll be fourth and 14, and the punt team comes on for the Bobcats. Bowling Green put the one good drive together, but it has not bred success. Short punt, fielded on the run by Clopton-Elsberry and almost to the 50-yard line, right in front of us at the 47. It's returned by Blake Kendall. That's where the Indian Hawks will take over, first and 10. Clopton-Elsberry would love at least one more score here in the first half. Give him some breathing room.
Bowling Green would like to cause a turnover.
Yeah, they would. That's a bad pass. Short of Taylor. They bring up second and 10. Four receiver set, three to the near side. High snap. Talbert going to take it up the middle. Sidesteps a man and falls forward for a gain of five. It'll be bring up third down. I think that was another kind of broke down play caused by the high snap, but he did get it for a nice gain. Officially four. I'll give him four and a half. Down to 4 minutes to go in the second quarter. Malcolm Lewis on the stop for Bowling Green. Third and six for the Indian Hawk offense. Talbert unloads it near side to Jamin Graham. Graham got past a man. He's across the 40 to the 35 and knocked out of bounds at the 34-yard line. That'll be enough for the first down. And then some. So Graham on the reception. And a fresh set for the Indian Hawks.
How many yards do you get on that?
Looks like it ended up being about, it's right where he was standing, so gain of about 10, about 12. First and 10 for the Indian Hawk offense. four men in the backfield right now. It's a pitch out to Blake Kendall on the far side. He gets through the first wave of Bowling Green defenders, then brought down close to the first down, gain of nine on the play. Short second down. Billings and Brandt on the stop for Bowling Green. But he was able to get through the first wave of Bowling Green defenders with a head of steam. Changes for the Bobcat defense. Before this short second down, they put some beef in the middle.
Some secret sauce.
Oh, miscommunication. And I don't think they got enough for the first time. First down this time, as Hammett was trying to crawl after he was down, get closer to the marker, but it's going to be third and one. No gain on the play. He was trying an army crawl. The officials were not fooled. Down to 2 minutes to go here in quarter number two. Indian Hawks with the ball, using some clock here on probably their final possession of the first half. Third and one play, less than a yard. Dropping back to throw. He's putting it deep, and it is caught. What a catch. There is a flag down, but Jamin Graham for the touchdown of 25 yards. I think we're going to have pass interference, but I think it's going to stand as well. Oh, it is offensive pass interference, so it's coming back. Jamin Graham was the one pushing off. How about that? Offensive pass interference. So instead of a touchdown or instead of a third and one, this one's going to be marched back. Clock stopped for the penalty. 1:42, and it's going to be third and 15. They move it all the way back to the 40-yard line of the Bobcats.
So they got a 15-yard penalty on top of it.
That was the penalty for the pass interference, yes. It's from the previous spot. And was there a loss of down in there, too? Because they've got fourth down.
No, it should be third and 15 from the 41-yard line.
The yard marker on the far side says four. The scoreboard says three.
Yeah.
Clopton-Elsberry needs some yards, though, and they're going to punt. It is fourth down. There was a loss of down there. High punt. Hits a man. Did it hit Kay? No, they say it didn't. I thought it hit him on the shoulder pad, but it is down. And Bowling Green will get it back. So the penalty kills a touchdown and the Clopton-Elsberry drive. And Bowling Green will have one more chance with a minute and 17 on the clock. Does Bowling Green have someone that can bust off a huge chunk of yardage? Murs on the reception on first down. And gets out of bounds to stop the clock. Gain of seven will be second and three. Minute 11, took 6 seconds off the clock. It'd be huge if Bowling Green could get in the end zone.
Very much. Very, very much.
Make it a little tighter. Give them some momentum heading into quarter number three. They're back to the air, and it is incomplete. Pafford heard the ball hit the ground and immediately shrugged his shoulders. Third down. Minute 8 on the clock. Pump fake. Coming near side, and it is thrown out of bounds. Down to 1:03, and it'll be fourth down and about four. Yeah, I think if you're Bowling Green, you got to punt away here. And that's what they're going to do. And we have a timeout taken. Timeout Bowling Green with 1:03. 28-6, Clopton-Elsberry leads the Bobcats in the Commissioner's Trophy game on the PeoplesTribune.com.
At Pike County Memorial Hospital, we know how important athletics are for your kids. But with an active lifestyle of sports come health risks and safety hazards. As a certified athletic trainer at Pike County Memorial Hospital, I work closely with our primary care physicians, orthopedic doctors, and physical therapists. We can make a difference between safe play and dangerous injuries for your athletes. Working with Louisiana, Bowling Green, and Clopton schools, our goal is to provide the best possible outcome for your athlete. I'm Ryan Pitzer, certified athletic trainer at Pike County Memorial Hospital. We're at work while your athletes are at play.
Proudly serving the area at 201 South Main in Vandalia, Cole Chiropractic Center is proud to support area high school sports action on TribCast. Cole Chiropractic Center invites you to call or stop by if you've suffered a sports injury, work injury, or been involved in any type of auto accident. Dr. Cole at Cole Chiropractic offers gentle chiropractic care, 24-hour emergency services with most insurances accepted. Don't suffer needlessly. Call 594-2663. Cole Chiropractic Center, 201 South Main. In Vandalia.
1:03 to go. Bowling Green facing a fourth down, and they punt away. They punt it to the far side. It's caught on the run and bringing it back through the defense and out of bounds. Or is he in the end zone? Did he make the end zone?
Yep.
He did. Return for a touchdown. Blake Kendall puts it in, and that is a dagger. That is an absolute dagger. Just put on by Kendall and the IndianHawks. Make it 34.
How many yards was that? About 50?
I think 45? He got it about the 45 yard line is where he fielded it. So that's what the return will be. Make it 45 in our book and a touchdown for Kendall and the IndianHawks. 51 seconds to go. Going for two. Clopton-Elsberry, as they always do. And they take it to the far side, and in for the two-point conversion is Frankie Black. Make it 36-6. 30-point lead for the IndianHawks. And they are in control of this game in the final minute at Bowling Green. Coach Scheibel gets excited, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. Very much.
We'll take a break. Come back. Less than a minute to go in the first half on TribCast.
If you're in the market for New Holland Farm equipment, an Exmark mower, or Kinsey planter, see Bowling Green Tractor today. Bowling Green Tractor is celebrating their completely new state-of-the-art shop and newly remodeled showroom to service all your parts, service, and equipment needs. Call Bowling Green Tractor 324-3337 or stop by and check out the expanded shop. Wishing all our area teams the best of luck this year, Bowling Green Tractor.
36-6, Clopton-Elsberry to kick off. Matt Kay deep for Bowling Green. And they go with a deep kick over the head of Dade. Kay will pick it up at the 25-yard line. Sidesteps a man. Actually, he was at the 15. Gets across the 20 to the 23-yard line. Good coverage on the return by Clopton-Elsberry. 46 seconds to go.
Who returned that?
Kay. Stay tuned for the State Farm Insurance TribCast Halftime, brought to you by Agent Cindy Blaylock in Louisiana and Ramsey Dickerman in Vandalia. 46 seconds on the clock. And Bowling Green, you either have to go for broke, throw a couple down the sideline, see what happens, or just take a knee and end this first half. Looks like they're going to take a knee and end the first half. We'll see. Nope, they're going to. And the play clock ran out. So a 5-yard penalty for delay of game. Being first and 15. Oh, no, they called the IndianHawks for coming across the line. There was no time on the clock. I don't know if any of the officials saw that. So it'll be first and 5 for Bowling Green. Back to throw, and it is caught. Light tackle, but Murs hauls it in. No flag, and it'll be a first down, and he gets out of bounds to stop the clock with 40 seconds to go.
Got how many yards on that?
Looks like about 15. Fresh set for the Bobcats.
The 44.
That one's up the middle, and it is caught. Good shoulder-to-shoulder hit, and down the sideline and out of bounds is number 81 for the Bobcats, Lane Sutton. Good reception and good smarts to get out of bounds. Rumbling down the middle of the field, got over to the sideline with 30 seconds to go. All the way down to the Clopton-Elsberry 25. That's a big play.
How many yards did he get on that?
He was at the 44. He's at the 25 now.
Okay.
About 30 yards. And a timeout taken. With 30 seconds to go, 36-6. Bowling Green trails, but they are moving here at the end of the half on TribCast.
If you buy electricity from Quiver River Electric Cooperative, you're more than a customer. You're a member, too. What does that mean? It means you have a say in how things run. It means you have equity in Quiver River when there's money left after expenses each year. It means that helping you save electricity is important because we're in this together. It means you have more than safe, reliable energy. You have power. You have people. Quiver River Electric Cooperative, owned by those they serve. CUIVRE.com.
Pike County Home Health can provide skilled home health services for homebound patients of Pike County. I'm Peggy Summers. Our agency offers a team approach with a registered nurse coordinating needed services. Home health services include skilled nursing, home health aid, social services, physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy, and a certified diabetic program. We do dressing changes, IV therapy, monitor medications, do diabetic foot care, and many other services.
The Pike County Health Department. Neighbors helping neighbors.
That pass is caught. That time by Bo Brandt. And he comes up shaking his fingers. He got out of bounds down to the 20. It'll be second and 5. Second and 5 for Bowling Green. From the 20. Trying to get a late score in here. What's the clock say? 25 seconds. Snap is good. Ball almost batted down, and then it is batted down on the other end. Brandt almost caught that in triple coverage. It'll be 3rd and 5. Game gets the play from the sideline. From Coach Marlock. Lots of receivers out there. 5 of them. 3 to the far side. 2 on the near side. Here's Gam going for the corner of the end zone, and it is incomplete. Good coverage by a couple of IndianHawks, and that'll bring up 4th down and 5. 17 seconds to go.
Who was that in the end zone? I couldn't see. Got a wall in front of me.
What's when you switch the other window there?
Yes, I've noticed.
It was Brandt, the intended target.
Got it.
Empty backfield. Everybody out trying to catch a ball here. And it is overthrown. And a turnover on downs. The intended target was Brandt again. Jamin Graham on the coverage for the IndianHawks. And Clopton-Elsberry will get it back with 14 seconds to go. So good movement until the timeout, and then they were 0 for 4. That's the danger. You allow the defense to also get rested and regrouped. And we'll see if Clopton-Elsberry takes a knee. They will. They're in a knee-taking formation, and that'll roll off the last 14 seconds. We played two quarters here in the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune. It's all Clopton-Elsberry so far. They lead it 36-6 over the Bobcats here at Bowling Green High School. There's the trophy. We're two quarters away from it being awarded here on thepeoplestribune.com.
Well, we're still catching every game, just a lot more from home than here in the stands, huh?
Yeah, and when we do get to go, Dad says we got to bring our own peanuts and stuff.
Looking for some extra ticket money this season? Let a State Farm agent do a free discount double check that could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
We'll always be there for this team, even when we can't actually be here.
Agent Cindy Blaylock will be there for you. 201 Georgia Street in Louisiana. Online at cindyblaylockagency.com.
State Farm is there. Discounts may vary state to state.
Hello, this is Mary Millen from Community State Bank of Missouri. Some financial institutions make you go through a lot of red tape to get a loan. At Community State Bank, we try to keep things simple. When you talk with us, you're talking to the people who make decisions. Next time you need a loan for whatever reason, come see us. You'll be glad you did. Community State Bank of Missouri, your hometown community bank since 1887, equal housing lender.
Serving our area for almost a century and a half, La Crosse Lumber Company has always offered quality building materials and hardware supplies at reasonable prices and still does today. Believing a satisfied customer is a repeat customer, La Crosse Lumber Company features free estimates, free delivery, and blueprint services available too. La Crosse Lumber proudly offers Owens Corning insulation and the top products in the industry. In Bowling Green, Louisiana, Clarksville, Vandalia, and beyond, or visit now at lacrosselumber.com.
It's time for the State Farm Insurance TribCast Halftime. Get a quote from an agent you trust. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Welcome back to Bowling Green Halftime here in the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune. And it's been mostly Clopton-Elsberry in the first half, leading it 36-6. The exclamation point was a punt return in the final minute. Bowling Green put together a drive after that, but took a timeout after reaching the 20-yard line. And from that point on, went 0 for 4 passing, couldn't get in the end zone on a couple of shots. And Bowling Green fizzles, turning it over on downs with 17 seconds to go. Clopton-Elsberry just took a knee after that to end the first half with the 30-point lead here at Bowling Green High School. Both bands are going to perform at halftime, so we'll enjoy that here at the stadium. But you can at least watch the formations as we talk about football here on the State Farm Insurance TribCast Halftime, brought to you by agent Cindy Blaylock in Louisiana and Ramsey Dickerman in Vandalia on thepeoplestribune.com.
Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out tough building projects. Bowling Green Ready Mix for all your concrete and concrete supplies and the only plant locally owned and operated. And Kearns Construction for new homes, remodeling jobs, repair work, and even snow removal. Just call 324-3433 and let the friendly, knowledgeable staff at Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction Company go to work for you.
No matter which team you're rooting for, Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford hopes all our area teams have a wonderful and successful season. Young Enterprise features Aki and Kent Feeds, Askrow and DeKalb Seeds, RCIS Crop Insurance, Fertilizer, Chemicals, Interstate Batteries, and more. Visit online at youngenterprisesinc.com for more information. Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford.
family health pharmacies in Bowling Green and Louisiana offer more prescriptions under more insurance plans for less. That should make you feel better. Family Health Pharmacies is there to help you when you're not feeling your best. Great gift ideas and half-price greeting cards, too. Two convenient locations to serve you. Bowling Green Pharmacy and Hearing Aid Center on the Square in Bowling Green and Family Drug, 301 Georgia in Louisiana. Family Health Pharmacies, just what the doctor ordered.
This is the State Farm Insurance TribCast Halftime, brought to you by agents Cindy Blaylock in Louisiana and Ramsey Dickerman in Vandalia. Note for the Bowling Green softball fans, they defeated South Callaway 7-1. And Sarah Harness had a complete game in that one, 13 strikeouts and a no-ball after getting a player of the game with a home run yesterday, was 2-for-4 with 3 RBI. Bowling Green 8-1 this season so far. Other scores around the area. The Van Far Indians are trailing, I believe, 18-0 to Montgomery County. Montgomery County winless so far, and that's not the worst news for Van Far. Boomer Connor also has re-aggravated that lower body injury that he's been dealing with the last couple of years, so he is out of the ballgame. I think he's going to put on a brace and try it in the second half, but we'll see if he can return and how much of a factor he is. He's off to a good start this season, so you'd hate for him to be out for any significant portion of time. North Callaway leads Mark Twain 18-8 at halftime. Looks like North Callaway has improved this season a little bit, and we'll try and get you a score on the Louisiana Centralia game as we go along. They trail 48-0 at the half, so just got that update as well. So Centralia up on Louisiana 48-0. So there's scores from around the area. Congratulations to the Lady Cats softball team on the win over a tough opponent in South Callaway today, 7-1. We'll take a break, come back, and talk about this one, give you your scoring report. This is the State Farm Insurance TribCast Halftime on the PeoplesTribune.com.
When you contract with a local company, you're sure to receive friendly, professional service. And that's just what you'll get with Orff Construction. A homegrown company, Orff Construction specializes in residential and commercial projects. A state-certified septic installer, Orff's offers backhoe, skid steer, and excavation services. Call 324-3552 for your next project. And remember, Orff's does basements, grading, and much more. Orff Construction in Bowling Green.
Celebrating their 20th anniversary, Lynn's Heritage House in Louisiana is proudly family-owned and operated. Since 1996, Lynn's Heritage House has offered affordable, home-like senior living featuring the independence you want and the services you need, with 24-hour staffing for the peace of mind that help is available when it's needed. You can rest assured that the residents at Lynn's Heritage House lead independent, rewarding lives. Elegant, affordable, assisted living. Lynn's Heritage House, 800 Kelly Lane in Louisiana.
The Law Office of Briscoe and Brandon reminds you that tonight's game is not only a competitive contest between these two schools, but it's also an educational experience for the students involved. Because high school activities are about learning life values, do your part in keeping our hometown sports a positive experience for everyone. You'll be teaching a positive lesson, and you'll be preserving a proud tradition. A message from the Law Office of Briscoe and Brandon. The choice of a lawyer is an important one and should not be based upon advertisements alone.
It's time for the State Farm Insurance TribCast Halftime. Get a quote from an agent you trust. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Recap the first half of action. Bowling Green won the coin toss, deferred to the second half, and we'll have the ball to start quarter number three. But they kicked it off, and the return by Guccione out to the 30 was ended by a huge hit from Michael Getty. That kind of set the tone for that possession for Clopton-Elsberry, as they couldn't get anything going and ended up punting back to the Bobcats. But it was mishandled deep by the Bobcats. They ended up falling on it after a weird return. And then on their next play, that kind of set the tone for that possession. Very next play, Bowling Green fumbles, and Jamin Graham falls on it. Mers charged with the fumble. But very next play again, Jordan Billings got it back for the Bobcats, recovering a bad snap. All sorts of wacky stuff in this little portion of the first quarter. Bobcats, Getty had a good carry, a couple of carries for 9 yards. Gamma carry, but there was a hold on that play. On the very next play, Gam throws an interception to Jamin Graham on a circus catch. I thought it rolled away. The Bowling Green coaches up here thought it rolled away, but they give the interception to Graham and the ball to the IndianHawks. And from that point, it was just a couple of plays. Incompletion, then a pass to Hammett for 15, a pass to Kendall in the end zone for 16, and the two-point conversion to Kendall was good as well. 8-0 IndianHawks on that play. And from that point on, Bowling Green was able to answer, get it to 8-6. A four-minute drive from their own 19-yard line. Murs scored on a 1-yard carry. Two-point conversion, though, was no good. 8-6, all IndianHawks after that. At the end of the or the beginning of the second quarter, the first play, two plays, and Derek Taylor catches a pass. Actually, Matt Kay caught the pass in the end zone, and it was taken away by the intended receiver, Derek Taylor, by for Clopton-Elsberry for the touchdown. The two-point conversion was no good. Then at the 6:59 mark, Clopton-Elsberry scores again, a 3.5-minute drive, 8 plays, Frankie Black into the end zone for 9 yards, 2-point conversion. This time on a pass to Hammett was good to make it 22-6. Less than a minute to convert a Bowling Green fumble into points later on for Clopton-Elsberry. 37-yard pass from Talbert to Taylor on a nice back shoulder catch. 2-point conversion was no good on that one, and the game was firmly in the Clopton-Elsberry IndianHawks' hands at that point. A couple of drives stalled out, and then with 1 minute to go, Blake Kendall returns a punt 45 yards for a touchdown down the far sideline. Frankie Black added the two-point conversion to make it 36-6 at the half. Bowling Green did have the nice drive. They're in the final minute and 17 seconds, but it fizzled after a timeout, 4 straight incompletions. And the ball went back to Clopton-Elsberry to end the half with the 30-point lead, 36-6. We'll take a break, come back with more, as now it's Clopton-Elsberry's band on the far side. After Bowling Green did their halftime show, now it's Clopton-Elsberry's turn. Then we'll get the players back out here and start the third quarter play in the Commissioner's Trophy game on thepeoplestribune.com.
In a season of falling temperatures and rising energy bills, your local Bryant professional stands ready to defend your home's comfort. Because when the temperature falls, Bryant turns up the heat efficiently.
Your protectors are Sparks Maintenance Contracting, Heating and Cooling in Bowling Green at 106 Business Highway 61 North, 324-6500, sparksheatingandcooling.com.
Bryant, whatever it takes.
At Pike County Memorial Hospital, we know how important athletics are for your kids. With an active lifestyle of sports comes health risks and safety hazards. I'm Eric Schaefer, certified athletic trainer at PCMH, and I work closely with our primary care physicians, orthopedic doctors, and physical therapists. Working with Clopton, Bowling Green, and Louisiana schools, we strive to prevent, diagnose, and treat a wide variety of injuries, ranging from sprains and fractures to heat stroke and concussions. In addition to sports coverage, we offer impact testing for head injuries as well as athletic enhancement for those athletes looking to get a step ahead of the competition. Rest assured, we're at work while your athletes are at play.
Proudly serving the area at 201 South Main in Vandalia, Cole Chiropractic Center is proud to support area high school sports action on TribCast. Cole Chiropractic Center invites you to call or stop by if you've suffered a sports injury, work injury, or been involved in any type of auto accident. Dr. Cole at Cole Chiropractic offers gentle chiropractic care, 24-hour emergency services with most insurances accepted. Don't suffer needlessly. Call 594-2663. Cole Chiropractic Center, 201 South Main in Vandalia.
If you're in the market for New Holland Farm Equipment, an Exmark mower, or Kinsey planter, see Bowling Green Tractor today. Bowling Green Tractor is celebrating their completely new state-of-the-art shop and newly remodeled showroom to service all your parts, service, and equipment needs. Call Bowling Green Tractor 324-3337 or stop by and check out the expanded shop. Wishing all our area teams the best of luck this year, Bowling Green Tractor.
Many of us are looking for ways to save energy, but please don't take safety shortcuts.
Quiver River Electric Cooperative reminds you to use electricity safely and take it seriously. Never touch a down power line after a storm. Always stay at least 10 feet away. Outdoors, look up for power lines and call 811 before you dig. Indoors, keep appliances away from water and don't overload circuits or use damaged cords. A safety message from Quiver River Electric Cooperative, owned by those we serve.
This is Kim Gam, RN, Certified Diabetes Educator and Coordinator of the Pike County Diabetes Counseling Program. Diabetes self-management education is designed to help you understand the disease and learn to manage it. Our nationally recognized program provides quality education and covers all aspects of diabetes management from basic to advanced skills. For more information, contact the Pike County Health Department, Home Health and Hospice at 573-324-2111.
The Pike County Health Department, neighbors helping neighbors.
It's time for the State Farm Insurance TribCast Halftime. Get a quote from an agent you trust. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Teams are back out of the locker room. Getting ready for the start of the third quarter. The officials are back out of the locker room as well. And it's 36-6 after two quarters. Clopton-Elsberry leading Bowling Green here in week number three. We went through the out-of-town scoreboard. We talked about the stats. How about our expectations are for the third quarter of this one. Bowling Green needs to get something going. I mean, the run game was pretty good in the first half, but they went away from it when they fell behind. But Getty hasn't carried the ball in a while. He came out with a head of steam. You got to get him back into it just because he fumbled on a great hit by Clopton-Elsberry. Doesn't mean that he's been ineffective. That was bad luck there. He had a perfect head-on ball hit and gave it up. But really, other than that, he was pretty good. And if you take him out of the game, it kind of takes the fire out of Bowling Green a little bit. So they got to get him involved again, both on the offense and defense, and maybe they can get something going here against Clopton-Elsberry. Against Clopton-Elsberry. So we'll take a break, come back with more of the State Farm Insurance TribCast Halftime on thepeoplestribune.com.
Well, we're still catching every game, just a lot more from home than here in the stands, huh?
Yeah, and when we do get to go, Dad says we got to bring our own peanuts and stuff.
Looking for some extra ticket money this season? Let a State Farm agent do a free discount double check that could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
We'll always be there for this team, even when we can't actually be here.
Agent Ramsey Dickerman will be there at 503 West Highway 54 in Vandalia. Online at RamseyDickerman.com.
State Farm is there. Discounts may vary state to state.
Are you still looking for a bank that knows you by name, offers convenient hours, and hometown service? Look no further than Community State Bank of Missouri. Hello, this is Deb Olson. Our Pleasant staff is here to welcome you and service all of your banking needs. Stop by our office in Bowling Green or Troy and experience the banking difference. Community State Bank of Missouri, your hometown community bank since 1887. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Serving our area for almost a century and a half, La Crosse Lumber Company has always offered quality building materials and hardware supplies at reasonable prices and still does today. Believing a satisfied customer is a repeat customer, La Crosse Lumber Company features free estimates, free delivery, and blueprint services available too. La Crosse Lumber proudly offers Owens Corning insulation and the top products in the industry. In Bowling Green, Louisiana, Clarksville, Vandalia, and beyond, or visit now at lacrosselumber.com.
Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out tough building projects. Bowling Green Ready Mix for all your concrete and concrete supplies, and the only plant locally owned and operated. And Kearns Construction for new homes, remodeling jobs, repair work, and even snow removal. Just call 324-3433 and let the friendly, knowledgeable staff at Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction Company go to work for you.
No matter which team you're rooting for, Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford hopes all our area teams have a wonderful and successful season. Young Enterprise features Akey and Kent Feeds, Askrow and DeKalb Seeds, RCIS Crop Insurance, Fertilizer, Chemicals, Interstate Batteries, and more. Visit online at youngenterprisesinc.com for more information. Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford.
Now more TribCast coverage of high school sports from the Bowling Green Tractor broadcast booth. Bowling Green Tractor, new and used equipment, parts and service, 1201 Business 61 South in Bowling Green.
Start of the second half from Bowling Green High School, the 2016 Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune. Coons on to kick off to start this second half. Twelve minutes on the clock, 30-point Clopton-Elsberry lead, and don't be surprised if they do something crazy here. They do kick it deep. Line drive kick. Kay's going to pick it up at the 10. Sidesteps. Does get away from the first man. Breaks through. Still on his feet and brought down across the 30-yard line. Good return by Matt Kay for the Bobcats. That's how we start the second half of this ball game from Bowling Green, first and 10 for the Bobcats. Three receiver set to the near side, and they give it to Getty to start the third quarter. And he gets a couple. It'll be second and 8. Coons and Anthony on the stop. For the Indian Hawks as the clock begins to run. Back to throw to the near side for Mers. He takes it back to the middle. Not much going on forward. And brought down at the 35-yard line. Gain of 2. Going to bring up third down. Mers on the catch. Be 3rd and 6. Lots of Indian Hawks there. Interesting route that Mers took with that ball. He's in motion again. Gets the handoff and it's snuffed out immediately. Loss on the play. Back across the 30. It'll bring up 4th down. And Mers slow to get up.
Mers on the run, stop.
Bring up 4th down.
By number 5, Derek Taylor.
Taylor was in there. And he's got the helmet off now. I think he may got a knee into the chops.
Bring up 4th and 12 for the Bobcats.
Deep man is Blake Kendall for the Indian Hawks for this punt. High snap. Gam gets it off. Ball bounces and is fielded by Kendall with one hand. He's across the 40 to the 35 of the Indian Hawks. Great starting field position for Clopton-Elsberry here in the second half. They'll have it 1st and 10. It's a good return by Blake Kendall.
35-yard line.
Gam did a good job just getting that kick off. 2 minutes gone here in the third quarter. And Clopton-Elsberry with good position for their first possession of the second half. Already up by 30. Put a man in motion. That's Hammett. The give is to Black. No, it's a pitch out to Hammett on the fake. And he's across the 35 to the 33, it looks like. Now they just give him like a yard and a half. Be 2nd down.
2nd and 8 for the Indian Hawks.
Official scorekeeper gives him a full 2. It's 2nd and long regardless. Clock running. Nearing 9 minutes remaining in the third. Pump fake, now a throw to the far side on the fade, and it is intercepted. Intercepted by Bowling Green. Noah Pafford on the pick, and Bowling Green gets it back. 1st and 10, Talbert. believe that's his second interception of the season. And Bowling Green has it, but they're inside their own 15. There is an injured player, I believe, on the far side being treated. That's Jamin Graham. He makes it to the sideline, along with the PCMH training crew. First and 10 for the Bobcats. Second possession of the second half. Give his to Getty. He was messed with, but still on his feet. My goodness, what a fight, and he gets almost 10 yards. I think he has enough for the first down. Flag comes in all over the place at the end. Everybody threw their flag at the end of that play. Yeah, he got to 11 on the play, but we'll see what happens afterward. They were all after the play, so it should be a fresh set regardless for Bowling Green. All four officials threw their flag. And it's against the Bobcats. Still first down.
Give me a break.
That's going to take it all the way back inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. So it'll be first and 25. Yeah, it's going to be first and 25. Well, something definitely happened when Getty was fighting for that first down. And I'm not sure if it was Michael or one of the other Bobcats that took exception. They finally get the ball set in the perfect or correct position. Now it's caught on the near side and rolled out of bounds. Is number 5, Stephen Mers for the Bobcats. So they got 15 back there, 16, and it's going to be 2nd and 9. So good gain that time by Mers.
A pass?
Yep. A little screen pass to Mers. High snap. Gam throws to the near side for Pafford. He makes a good cut, and I think he's got enough for the first down. He does, across the 35 to the 38, and a fresh set. So the first and 25, no problem for the Bobcat offense this time, and it's good for a first.
Get 10 yards on that?
About 13. And a timeout for the Indian Hawks.
I was saying, every time Bowling Green calls a timeout. Yeah,
they kind of sputter afterward. We'll take a timeout as well. 36-6, Clopton-Elsberry lead. Bowling Green with the ball, 8:05 to go in the third quarter on TribCast.
Family Health Pharmacies in Bowling Green and Louisiana offer more prescriptions under more insurance plans for less. That should make you feel better. Family Health Pharmacies is there to help you when you're not feeling your best. Great gift ideas and half-price greeting cards, too. Two convenient locations to serve you. Bowling Green Pharmacy and Hearing Aid Center on the Square in Bowling Green and Family Drug, 301 Georgia in Louisiana. Family Health Pharmacies, just what the doctor ordered.
Now more TribCast coverage of high school sports from the Bowling Green Tractor broadcast booth. Bowling Green Tractor, your X-Mark professional turf care equipment dealer, 1201 Business 61 South in Bowling Green.
First and 10 for the Bobcats. After the couple of good gains on throws to Mers and Pafford. Here's fake to Getty. Pump fake. Gam, another pump fake. Puts it to the far side. It's caught. And that's Pafford again. He had nine and now pushing and shoving after the whistle again. But it ends with hugs between the Indian Hawks and Bobcats. They're going to give him forward progress for a gain of nine, second down and less than a yard. Here's Getty, and he got enough. All the way to the 50, gain of three, and a first down for the Bobcats. Michael Getty with the first down run. After they reset the sticks, they'll start the clock in. 7:20 to go in the third quarter. On first down, Gam back to throw. To the far side and through the hands of Bo Brandt. Incomplete, it'll be second and 10.
Number 20, Kevin Hammett on the defense.
Hammett was there on the coverage for the Indian Hawks.
Who was it?
It was intended for Brandt.
Pass?
Yes, incomplete.
I'm running too many things here.
You're running a pencil and a phone.
Hey.
High snap. It's through the hands of Gam, and it is recovered by the Bobcats. Good work. Who was it? Getty fell on it. But it's a big loss back across their own 40. It's going to be about third and 21, loss of 11 on the play.
Mm.
But they didn't lose the ball, so.
Yeah. They were able to make up a big penalty last go, so.
So maybe they can make up the fumble here. That is caught, and it's made up. He's got almost first down yardage.
Wow.
That's Pafford. Noah to Noah. And it'll bring up fourth down, but very manageable, and they're going to go for it. Colin Lockhart finally got him, stopped him short of the first down. Fourth and a full one. Big play for both squads here. They got the beef in there for Bowling Green. Almost two offensive lines, and they have enough. He's across and still on his feet. Noah Gam gets the first down. But this stuff is taking time. You've got 30 points to make up. We're past the midway point of the third quarter. The beef's still in there. It's another run, and this one snuffed out. Nothing there. It'll be second and 10. Not sure why they were trying a goal line play with Mers, and Mers comes out of it injured. So even worse for Bowling Green. Not only did they have a one-yard play in there for first and 10, but they lost one of their top offensive players in the process. Getty in it, running back now for Bowling Green. Primarily to block. The ball is thrown behind the intended target. That time it was.
Gans pass calls incomplete. Intended for number 8, Rob. We got my 3rd and 10.
Trent Robb was the intended target that time. His first target tonight. 5 minutes to go, 5:01 on the clock, actually, with the incompletion. 3rd and 10. Damn, flush from the pocket, and that, is it a fumble? They're going to call intentional grounding. Game was still in the pocket when he threw that. There wasn't a receiver in sight. Intentional grounding. So that's going to back him up even further and force fourth down. So the drive stalls after some early success. Still wondering the play call there on first down. Had a goal line play in on first down. So that puts the ball at the 50-yard line. It's on the Bobcat side of the 50. Punt team on. And he gets it off. Caught on the fly by Kendall. And a short return out to the 30-yard line. That's where the Indian Hawks will take over first and 10.
Takes the ball to about the 30-yard line. We're brought down by 89.
4:48 to go in the third quarter. First and 10 for Talbert and the Clopton-Elsberry offense, and he's going for the throws here early. Down the sideline, and it is incomplete off the fingertips of Kevin Hammett. He had nothing but green grass in front of him. That'll bring up second and 10. That was perfectly placed, hit him in stride, and he just let it go off his fingers. And he knew it, too. He just missed out on a touchdown. So second and 10 for Clopton-Elsberry. That was their home run. See what they do now. Talbert reverses it and overthrows. And it is called an incomplete pass. Be third and 10. Black, the intended target. Do you go back to the home run here? 4:35 to go, third quarter.
Why not?
I mean, it is. It's kind of like that why not point in the game. You're up by 30 points. Third and 10. And they're going to run this time. And Talbert has enough for the first down. Gains 11 and gets a fresh set. Out across the 40 to the 41. Now you go for the long ball. Pafford finally stopped him after a gain of 10. And the clock running down to 4:20.
Where are we?
At the 41-yard line of the Indian Hawks.
Okay.
Talbert puts it away again and trying to run, spins off one tackle. Gains about 3 before he's knocked back by number 44 for the Bobcats, Malcolm Lewis. What it does, gains a little bit of yardage, keeps the clock moving.
I'd say that's just what Coach Mike Scheibel is wanting.
Back to throw. Goes up the middle, and it is caught. Caught. Kevin Hammett. Brandt finally got him, and Hammett said, "I didn't even touch the ground." Said, "I just laid on Bo Brandt," but the officials weren't buying it and blew the whistle. Well, we have an 18-3 score. Banfar trailing after three.
That's right.
So they got a field goal. That's rare.
How much did Hammett get on that one?
About 20 yards. They're going for more this time. It is incomplete. Matt Kay on the coverage. Taylor, the intended target. It was overthrown a little bit. It'll bring up second down and 10. Under 3 minutes to go in the third. Second and 10 for Clopton-Elsberry. They're going again. Here's Talbert down the far sideline, and it is underthrown this time. Intended target was Matt Klopsik. That'll bring up third down and 10. Pafford was there on the coverage. So it'll bring up third down and long. The Bowling Green coach is up here saying contain, contain. You got four wide receivers out there, a man in the backfield along with quarterback Talbert. And it's a fake handoff. Talbert takes it, and he's run down after a short gain. It'll be fourth and about eight, gain of two. Dade on the stop. Pafford also there. Down to 2.5 minutes to go in the quarter. Clopton, Elsberry going for it here on fourth down. Fourth and eight. Back to throw as Talbert steps into the pocket, throws it up the middle and overthrows Blake Kendall, and it'll be a turnover on downs back to the Bobcats. At the 38-yard line, and the Bobcat offense comes onto the field. Change up the personnel, respot the ball, and we'll go again with 2:02 remaining in the third. Trying to update you on other scores as we go along here in the second half. 18-3. Banfar trailing Montgomery. Not many other updates from around the region right now. Louisiana was trailing big to Centralia at the half, 48 to nothing. Banfar trailing 18-3. Saw Mark Twain was trailing heading into the second half, I believe 18-8.
A key piece of Banfar's offense is on the sidelines right now with shin trouble.
Boomer Connor, yeah. They say he was going to try and brace it.
Yes.
Getty up the middle. Short gain. About two on first down. Scott Coons on the stop. Throw to the near side. It is dropped. Dropped by Pafford. He had enough green in front of him at the time if he would have caught it cleanly to get the first down. Instead, it's third and eight.
Pafford was looking at that ball like it had betrayed him.
It did.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if he was looking at the ball or his hands like that. Going deep is Gam, and it's intercepted. Intercepted by the Indian Hawks, and going back the other way is Klopsik. Klopsik down to the 10, the 5, and he's in for the defensive touchdown for Clopton-Elsberry.
Passes intercepted by number 1,
a defensive score. That's the second week in a row that Gam has thrown a pick 6. Indian Hawks in the end zone again on the interception return for a touchdown by Klopsik. 1:12 to go in the third quarter. They'll go for 2. He couldn't have been hit more in stride either. He was off to the races. Caught it at top speed. Trying to make it 44-6. Throw through the hands of a couple of Bobcats. The closest Clopton-Elsberry receiver was Kendall, and he was 2-3 yards away. So the conversion fails. Clopton-Elsberry leads 42-6 here in the third quarter, late in the third quarter, on the PeoplesTribune.com.
When you contract with a local company, you're sure to receive friendly, professional service. And that's just what you'll get with Orff Construction. A homegrown company, Orff Construction specializes in residential and commercial projects. A state-certified septic installer, Orff's offers backhoe, skid steer, and excavation services. Call 324-3552 for your next project. And remember, Orff's does basements, grading, and much more. Orff Construction in Bowling Green.
Now more TribCast coverage of high school sports from the Bowling Green Tractor broadcast booth. Bowling Green Tractor, your New Holland agriculture equipment dealer, 1201 Business 61 South in Bowling Green.
What's the worst part of a turnover turning into points, like a pick six, is that you have to go right back out there onto offense with that oh no mentality. Kay, a good return. Gets him across the 35 to the 37. That's where Bowling Green will start, first and 10. Koontz again on the stop. 57 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Ball's going to be spotted at the 36-yard line. First and 10, Bobcats.
And it is over the threshold now, so the clock running. Here's Getty. Threw a couple of tackles, and he has first down yardage. Gain of 11 for Getty, and he moves it across the 45 to the 46-yard line. Got Lockard finally with the stop, but a gain of 11. And with 7 seconds, they'll just come to the sideline for the quarter break. After three, Clopton-Elsberry leading the Commissioner's Trophy game over Bowling Green 42-6 here on the PeoplesTribune.com.
Celebrating their 20th anniversary, Lynn's Heritage House in Louisiana is proudly family-owned and operated. Since 1996, Lynn's Heritage House has offered affordable, home-like senior living featuring the independence you want and the services you need. With 24-hour staffing for the peace of mind that help is available when it's needed. You can rest assured that the residents at Lynn's Heritage House lead independent, rewarding lives. Elegant, affordable, assisted living. Lynn's Heritage House, 800 Kelly Lane in Louisiana.
The Law Office of Briscoe and Brandon reminds you that tonight's game is not only a competitive contest between these two schools, but it's also an educational experience for the students involved. Because high school activities are about learning life values, do your part in keeping our hometown sports a positive experience for everyone. You'll be teaching a positive lesson, and you'll be preserving a proud tradition. A message from the Law Office of Briscoe and Brandon. The choice of a lawyer is an important one and should not be based upon advertisements alone.
Start of the fourth quarter, and it's a run on the first play of the final frame, and Genny picks up about 4 bring up second down and six. Yeah, they officially give him three, so we'll stay him with that and make it a 7 yard or a 3 yard pickup, second and seven. Getty again. He's getting the majority of the carries here, and he bounces off a man and gets enough yardage for the first down. Yep, gain of seven and a fresh set. They gave him seven, but said he was an inch short. So get another carry here. High snap. Getty cuts back, and he loses the yardage and loses the ball. It's under that pile somewhere. I think Bowling Green fell on it. Nope. Clopton-Elsberry comes away with it. Oh, my goodness. Second fumble of the night for Michael. And it goes back to the IndianHawks, first and 10. Now, the first one you couldn't fault him for, this one. He didn't get put away well enough, and it goes back to the IndianHawks, who can run some clock here. Down, already 2 minutes gone in the fourth on the running clock. Far side. And that's Kendall again with a gain of six. Be second and four.
To number 11, Kendall. Looks like he's brought down over there by number 22, Matt Kay.
Kay finally stopped him.
Second and three.
Yeah, they ended up giving him seven. Had a better spot on the ball than I initially thought. Stay tuned for the Bowling Green Ready Mix TribCast post game after this one, where we'll award the Commissioner's Trophy. Talbert, enough for the first down, but then a flag comes in at the end. Kaylee O'Dade on the stop for the Bobcats. And we'll see what it is. It's a face mask against the offense. Offensive face mask. That's an interesting one. So that's a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. And still second down. So it'll move it back across the 50, across the 45 of the IndianHawks to the 44-yard line. Back to throw. Talbert to the far side, and it is caught. Caught on the far sideline. What an adjustment made by the receiver, Blake Kendall. Enough for the first down, and then some out to the 35 of Bowling Green. That's a 25-yard gain. I don't think penalties mean much to this Clopton-Elsberry team. I think they look at it as a challenge. Fresh set here. Give up the middle, bouncing off one man, but not finding any room. Is
number 89.
That's Brendan Morse, his first carry of the night. Getty on the stop. For a loss of about 6 inches, it'll bring up second down.
Second 11.
So some starters starting to trickle to the sidelines for Clopton-Elsberry as the clock's down to 7:40 to go in this ball game. Morse gets his first carry. Talbert, pump fake. Flushed. Coming to the near side. Does put it in the air, and it's thrown away. Good coverage by the Bobcat defense. Swarns was the primary chaser. Getty at his back. Brings up third down. .650 to go here in the fourth quarter of this Commissioner's Trophy game. And this one belongs to Clopton-Elsberry tonight. They're going to bring it back to Clarksville. Talbert throws across the middle. It is caught. Turning with it, trying to go back upfield, was Kevin Hammett. That'll bring up fourth down. Fourth and five. Bo Brandt on the coverage. Clock continues to run. Now the midway point of the fourth quarter.
Who had that?
Hammett. Big fourth down play. Throw across the middle, and it's overthrown, and a turnover on downs. Hammett, the intended target. Brandt there on the coverage, and it'll go back to the Bobcats. Clock continues to run. Now they say stop that clock. And a timeout is called with 5:33 to go in the fourth quarter. 42-6, Clopton-Elsberry leads Bowling Green on TribCast.
In a season of falling temperatures and rising energy bills, your local Bryant professional stands ready to defend your home's comfort. Because when the temperature falls, Bryant turns up the heat efficiently.
Your protectors are Sparks Maintenance Contracting Heating and Cooling in Bowling Green at 106 Business Highway 61 North, 324-6500, sparksheatingandcooling.com.
Bryant, whatever it takes.
At Pike County Memorial Hospital, we know how important athletics are for your kids. But with an active lifestyle of sports come health risks and safety hazards. As a certified athletic trainer at Pike County Memorial Hospital, I work closely with our primary care physicians, orthopedic doctors, and physical therapists. We can make a difference between safe play and dangerous injuries for your athletes. Working with Louisiana, Bowling Green, and Clopton schools, our goal is to provide the best possible outcome for your athlete. I'm Ryan Pitzer, certified athletic trainer at Pike County Memorial Hospital. We're at work while your athletes are at play.
And Ryan's here tonight.
Indeed.
Providing care. And Dade goes off a tackle, and he's coming back to the near side. He's crossed the 40, across the 50, and finally knocked out of bounds. Kaylee O'Dade gets a gain of 20 before he's knocked out. Good reverse by Kaylee. We're down to 5 minutes to go in the ball game. First and 10 from midfield for Bowling Green. Dade, pass tipped, and it is incomplete. Almost there with a few Indian Hawks. Kendall ended up trapping the ball. Bring up second down. Second and 10 from midfield. Four to go. Dade keeps it himself, and no gain on that play. Some contact away from the ball. Who was involved in that? Garrett Swarns. Couldn't see the Indian Hawk player. But they just got tangled, I think. Not sure what that was about. I think there was a little bit of a runoff there of the clock by the official. High snap, and then he fumbles it. Dade picks it back up, but he goes down for a four-yard loss. That'll bring up third down, or fourth down. Fourth and 15, loss of four or five on the play. This one just about in the books. Over the head and falling on it. Bad snap before a punt, and it goes all the way down to the 19-yard line. That's where Clopton-Elsberry will start this possession. My goodness, that was worse than a fumble, I think. I mean, worse than than the punt, although not the way Clopton-Elsberry's been returning things. By the time this play comes to the line, there'll be 2 minutes left in the contest, and Jerry has stolen the bell. I mean, he's going to present the bell. There it is. How's he have that and his camera?
I'm going down to take a
picture. All right. April heading away from the broadcast booth. Victory formation. They're going to let the play clock go all the way down. And with a minute 38, they start taking a knee. So Clopton-Elsberry got to bring the commissioner's trophy back to Clarksville. And they start to celebrate. Not sure where Jerry is going with the trophy. Minute to go. Taking a knee again. Bring up third down. Our final in this one, 42-6. Clopton-Elsberry will be the victors and go to 3-0 on the season. Bowling Green will fall to 0-3. I think Van Farr was not looking like they were going to make it out of week three undefeated. There it is. We'll be back here for Bowling Green Van Farr next week. And look at Scheibel getting into it. He loves it. Clopton-Elsberry, your Commissioner's Trophy champions for 2016. It's quite a way to start the holiday weekend with this victory. We'll take a break, come back with the presentation of the trophy after the handshakes and the start of the Bowling Green Ready Mix TribCast postgame on thepeoplestribune.com.
Proudly serving the area at 201 South Main in Vandalia, Cole Chiropractic Center is proud to support area high school sports action on TribCast. Cole Chiropractic Center invites you to call or stop by if you've suffered a sports injury, work injury, or been involved in any type of auto accident. Dr. Cole at Cole Chiropractic offers gentle chiropractic care, 24-hour emergency services with most insurances accepted. Don't suffer needlessly. Call 594-2663. Cole Chiropractic Center, 201 South Main in Vandalia.
If you're in the market for New Holland Farm equipment, an Exmark mower, or Kinsey planter, see Bowling Green Tractor today. Bowling Green Tractor is celebrating their completely new state-of-the-art shop and newly remodeled showroom to service all your parts, service, and equipment needs. Call Bowling Green Tractor 324-3337 or stop by and check out the expanded shop. Wishing all our area teams the best of luck this year,
Bowling Green Tractor.
If you buy electricity from Quiver River Electric Cooperative, you're more than a customer. You're a member, too. What does that mean? It means you have a say in how things run. It means you have equity in Quiver River when there's money left after expenses each year. It means that helping you save electricity is important because we're in this together. It means you have more than safe, reliable energy. You have power. You have people. Quiver River Electric Cooperative, owned by those they serve. CUIVRE.com.
It's time for the Bowling Green Ready Mix TribCast postgame, brought to you by Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out building projects.
Jerry Hickerson hands the Commissioner's Trophy presented by the People's Tribune to the Clopton-Elsberry IndianHawks. Champions for 2016, they raise it high above their heads. They beat Bowling Green tonight in the Commissioner's Trophy game, 42-6, to take that trophy, that beautiful bell, back to Clarksville with them. Yeah, they may let Elsberry have it in their trophy case for a day or two, but this one in the books, 42-6, our final, as the IndianHawks move to 3-0, while the Bobcats fall to 0-3 here in the 2016 season. We'll take a break, come back with the final scoring report after this. This is the Bowling Green Ready Mix TribCast postgame on the PeoplesTribune.com.
Pike County Home Health can provide skilled home health services for homebound patients of Pike County. I'm Peggy Summers. Our agency offers a team approach with a registered nurse coordinating needed services. Home health services include skilled nursing, home health aid, social services, physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy, and a certified diabetic program. We do dressing changes, IV therapy, monitor medications, do diabetic foot care, and many other services.
The Pike County Health Department, neighbors helping neighbors.
Well, we're still catching every game, just a lot more from home than here in the stands, huh?
Yeah, and when we do get to go, Dad says we got to bring our own peanuts and stuff.
Looking for some extra ticket money this season? Let a State Farm agent do a free discount double check that could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
We'll always be there for this team, even when we can't actually be here.
Agent Cindy Blaylock will be there for you. 201 Georgia Street in Louisiana. Online at cindyblaylockagency.com.
State Farm is there. Discounts may vary state to state.
Hello, this is Mary Millen from Community State Bank of Missouri. Some financial institutions make you go through a lot of red tape to get a loan. At Community State Bank, we try to keep things simple. When you talk with us, you're talking to the people who make decisions. Next time you need a loan for whatever reason, come see us. You'll be glad you did. Community State Bank of Missouri, your hometown community bank since 1887. Equal housing lender.
Serving our area for almost a century and a half, La Crosse Lumber Company has always offered quality building materials and hardware supplies at reasonable prices, and still does today. Believing a satisfied customer is a repeat customer, La Crosse Lumber Company features free estimates, free delivery, and blueprint services available too. La Crosse Lumber proudly offers Owens Corning insulation and the top products in the industry. In Bowling Green, Louisiana, Clarksville, Vandalia, and beyond, or visit now at lacrosselumber.com.
Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out tough building projects. Bowling Green Ready Mix for all your concrete and concrete supplies, and the only plant locally owned and operated. And Kearns Construction for new homes, remodeling jobs, repair work, and even snow removal. Just call 324-3433 and let the friendly, knowledgeable staff at Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction Company go to work for you.
This is the Bowling Green Ready Mix TribCast postgame, brought to you by Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out building projects.
Our final scoring report of this ball game is Clopton-Elsberry wins the Commissioner's Trophy game presented by the People's Tribune, 42-6. There in the first quarter, things got underway for Clopton-Elsberry. Stephen Talbert to carry for a touchdown, 8:51 to go in the first, made it 8-0 after a two-point conversion. Excuse me. I'm in the wrong game. I was in the first Clopton-Elsberry game. The only scoring in the second half, I'll tell you that, was the Klopsik interception return, the pick six, and that pretty well sealed it. It was a interception for 40 yards, I believe, by Klopsik as Matt took it down the sideline with a minute 12 to go in the third quarter. That's the only score of the second half in this ball game as Clopton-Elsberry sealed it. But it started with the offense as Clopton-Elsberry finished the first quarter with just a 8-6 lead. But on the first play of the second quarter, scored on a Derek Taylor reception in the corner of the end zone. A ball he actually stole from Matt Kay to make it 14-6. The two-point conversion was no good. Made it 22-6 with 3.5-minute drive in the second quarter. Frankie Black finishes with a 9-yard touchdown, two-point conversion. A pass to Hammett was good to make it 22-6 at that point. Bowling Green fumbled, and then the Clopton-Elsberry IndianHawks turned that into points with the 37-yard pass from Talbert to Taylor again. Two-point conversion was no good on that one. And then came the punt return. That was fantastic by Blake Kendall. Returned a punt 45 yards. Frankie Black got the two-point conversion, made it 36-6. That was all the scoring in the first half, and then that interception return by Klopsik in the second half to seal the deal for the IndianHawks. Our player of the game and winning coach are on their way up, so we'll take a break, come back, get them into the booth here on the PeoplesTribune.com. It's the Bowling Green Ready Mix TribCast postgame.
No matter which team you're rooting for, Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford hopes all our area teams have a wonderful and successful season. Young Enterprise features A. Key and Kent Feeds, Askro and DeKalb Seeds, RCIS Crop Insurance, Fertilizer, Chemicals, Interstate Batteries, and more. Visit online at youngenterprisesinc.com for more information. Young Enterprises Incorporated of New Hartford.
Family Health Pharmacies in Bowling Green and Louisiana offer more prescriptions under more insurance plans for less. That should make you feel better. Family Health Pharmacies is there to help you when you're not feeling your best. Great gift ideas and half-price greeting cards, too. Two convenient locations to serve you. Bowling Green Pharmacy and Hearing Aid Center on the Square in Bowling Green and Family Drug, 301 Georgia in Louisiana. Family Health Pharmacies, just what the doctor ordered.
This is the Bowling Green Ready Mix TribCast postgame, brought to you by Bowling Green Ready Mix and Kearns Construction, your high-quality 1-2 punch to knock out building projects.
And we're joined here in the Bowling Green Tractor broadcast booth by our Community State Bank TribCast player of the game with the big return for a touchdown, Blake Kendall. Big on both sides of the ball tonight, but how good does it feel to take that bell back home with you?
Greatest feelings I've ever had right now. We promised our seniors we'd give it to them, and we did.
Well, it's a unique trophy, isn't it?
I wasn't expecting that. I had totally forgotten about it, honestly.
But things heavy. It's got some weight to it.
That's what they said.
You didn't hoist it?
No, I haven't.
It's the Stanley Cup, you know. It's it's just like that. You gotta hold it above your head.
I'll go touch it.
But this ball game, you guys came in. I heard there was some social media talk on the other side, but you guys didn't really fall for that. You just went out there, played your ball game, and after kind of a slow start, got things rolling and kind of made a statement out here tonight.
Yeah. Especially with the social media thing, our coach preached to us, you know, don't get involved in it. We expected it, and I think we took it really well.
Well, you let your play do the talking tonight. there was a few hits. You know, 33 on the other side can really hit, but you guys weathered that and laid some out there as well. it looked like it kind of got rough in the trenches tonight. Did you kind of feel that?
I do feel my body's getting pretty sore as I started to calm down.
Well, yeah, that adrenaline starts to lower a little bit. Well, I'll let you get out of here, get some ice. Congratulations on the
Thank
win. Congratulations on that return, and we'll see you soon. Our Community State Bank TribCast Player of the Game tonight, Blake Kendall of the Clopton-Elsberry IndianHawks. Thanks. And let's get Coach Mike Scheibel in here. And a guest. Can you get that on there? You need some help?
Hopefully we don't get it stolen.
Coach, how much does that trophy, that bell, mean to you guys?
This is something, I mean, we haven't, as a group, the seniors, myself here since I've been here, you know, we haven't beat Bowling Green, and that's something that's kind of been on our bucket list. And, you know, I got to give them credit. They came out strong. You know, Getty, that kid runs hard.
Yeah.
He's hard to take down.
Well, I think that first hit on the opening kickoff kind of stunned you guys a little bit. But after that, you were able to regroup. It took a possession or two, but you got it going.
Yeah, and we stuttered a little bit on offense tonight. We're still, believe it or not, I mean, being in week three, you're still kind of working out the kinks. You know, our offense has only played one full game because we've put in our second string a lot. And, you know, so this is the first time Talbert's taking a snap in the second half this year. So, you know, and we were trying to call different things and stuff like that. But, you know, in the grand scheme of things, it just comes down to our athletes. It's nothing that I'm doing or coaching staff. It's these guys came in this summer. They had a goal in mind, and that's what they wanted to do.
You made a decision in the offseason to loosen the strings. You let McCann take over the defense completely. Three games, a total of 12 points. How big has that been?
You know, Cody's one of those guys where the last couple of years, him and I tried to run it together, and I mean, I thought we've been in the right spots.
Uh-huh.
A lot of that has to do with we have seniors now.
Uh-huh. Yeah, exactly.
That's the number one thing on defense.
I was trying to give him all the credit, but
oh no, I'm getting there. No, Cody has done it. I gave it to him, and he's really he's made it his baby, and he's taken off with it, and he's done a great job. Also, JT Wells has been a guy who's been helping us out. He's a friend of Coach Kreger's. From Lindenwood, and he ran this defense in high school. So those guys, man, that's why I tell them. I told your guy down there, take pictures of McCann. The defense was the real hero tonight.
Uh-huh.
We knew offense were going to score points.
Yeah.
But Coach McCann did a great job going into this. And yeah, you're right. Our defense is playing great right now.
Yeah, it's so cool to have a complete team. Some teams, you know, can score the points. You learned that last year, but the defense had holes. To have the total package, it really strikes fear into a lot of opponents down the line. That this is going to be a really hard game for them.
Yeah, I mean, anytime someone plays us now, they hopefully see this and say, you know, but look at those guys. They're not just a flashy offense.
Mm-hmm.
They're a defense who's going to hit. They're a defense who's going to get after it. They're a defense
that'll frustrate you.
Absolutely. And we've really worked. We worked on our tackling a lot. Too. Uh-huh. And I'll tell you what, we've improved that big time.
Pretty girl.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations on the win, Coach. I'll let you get back to your team and enjoy a year with the bell, the Commissioner's Trophy.
Thank you very much. It's an honor to have it. And you know what? The boys, I just want to say one more thing. The boys deserve it. Again, it's not us coaching staff. It's that senior group that is just – they are the engine to this train right now, and they're taking it, and they're taking what the coaches tell them, and they're just executing like crazy. And as a coach, there's nothing more exciting whenever all guys are firing on all cylinders.
Well, now the train has a bell. Congratulations.
Hey, there we go. I like that. Thank you very much.
That's Coach Mike Scheibel here in the Bowling Green Ready Mix TribCast post-game, and congratulations to him and his Clopton-Elsberry team again on winning the Commissioner's Trophy. Bye-bye. By a final of 42-6. We're going to wrap it up here. They're about to turn out the lights here at this Bowling Green Stadium. And so we will see you next week with a couple of days of softball, and then be back here on Friday night as Van Farr comes into Bowling Green for another EMO All Tribcast showdown here at the home of the Bobcats. So final again, Clopton-Elsberry improves to 3-0 with a 42-6 win over the 0-3 Bowling Green Bobcats. We'll see you next week here on the PeoplesTribune.com. Good night, everybody.